हेलो ऑल, गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम टू द शो।
गुड इवनिंग अभिषेक। हेलो, वेलकम एवरीवन।
इट इज अवर प्लेजर टू इन्फॉर्म यू ऑल दैट वी हैव डॉक्टर राजीव वर्मा सर विद अस टुडे इन द इवनिंग, एंड डिस्पाइट ही इज गेटिंग मल्टीपल नंबर ऑफ कॉल्स एंड मैसेजेस ऑन व्हाट्सएप, आई थिंक ही विल बी एबल टू डू जस्टिस विद ऑल द पीपल टुडे। गुड इवनिंग सर एंड वेलकम टू द शो।
Good
Good evening,
evening.
sir.
Yes, good evening.
The most versatile man in Indian dentistry.
I talk about it.
Okay. So let us introduce the list of today's panelists. First of all, I would like to introduce Dr. Sanyogita ma'am. She is from Mumbai. She passed out in 2001. She is practicing dentist. She is married from last 15 years. She is having one son. She is a all-rounder woman. She is a housewife. She is working. She is practicing. Welcome, Dr. Sanyogita, to the show, ma'am, tonight, today.
Thank you. Thank
Hello,
you.
Dr. Sanyogita. Welcome back to the panel.
Hello. Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Anand and Abhishek, for inviting. Thank you, sir, for accepting invitation in from WDA and addressing this. This platform. Yeah.
Next, we have today Dr. Payal. She passed out in 2008. She is having 10 years of marriage and two kids. Due to kids, she used to have her own practice, but due to kids, somehow she stopped. But now her husband, who is also a dentist, and they, along with other associates, she is managing it. Welcome, ma'am, to the show.
Yeah.
Welcome, Dr. Payal.
Hi.
Welcome,
Hi, sir.
Dr. Payal.
Hi.
Hi.
Next, we have Dr. Samida Patil. She is from Vardha. She is married since 2007. She had two clinics after birth of her first daughter. She is running practice. She was running practice in Latur. Now she is in Pune and she will be starting her practice very soon. Welcome, Dr. Patil, to the show.
Hello all. Good evening, sir. Good evening, WD team and all the other panelists. Hello.
Good evening, Dr. Samita.
And the final panelist is we have Dr. Kavar Malik. Welcome, Dr. Kavar, to the show. I have just a moment. Welcome, ma'am.
Hello.
She's into marriage from last 7 years and have one daughter, and she is managing two clinics.
Good evening. Thank you
Welcome
so much.
To Over to you, sir. Over to you, sir.
Oh, good. Oh, good. On time performance as usual. After a great evening yesterday with Dr. Christian Portman. 5,500 people watching the program in 2 hours' time. And I don't know, I've not checked today because since morning, I've been busy with women dentists from all over India. I've been sending messages. Some of them I suspect whether they've really written their own names. Some of them are completely anonymous about their questions. Some of them refuse to come online like these four bold women which you are seeing in front of you. You know?
Yeah.
Some of them actually told me, sir, आपको सुनने के बाद में डिवोर्स नहीं होगा ना?
नहीं होगा सर, नहीं होगा सर.
But one thing is very common. Most women who are listening to me today or will be joining in slowly or later on when they watch, see a watch party or the retelecast, they'll all be interested in what I am going to talk about, the dreaded mother-in-law. Huh? Of course, the young dentist in front of me would say, Nana, my mother-in-law is a sweet rasgulla. Array, if your mother-in-law was a sweet rasgulla, Ekta Kapoor would not have earned so much money in life. Okay, it's not possible. So there is no mother-in-law in life except 2%. 98% mother-in-laws are mother-in-laws, including my mother was a mother-in-law. So I have experience of mother-in-laws. But so welcome everybody. Before I go further, let me, I will bhule bhatke yahan kaha aa gaya yaar, Vikash Gupta. You are the first man to
attend. Yeah.
Join in today. Yes. And then I could see Yogesh Doshi. Ah, Yogesh is here. Pandharpur Varun, Sita. I love it. Then of course Kalida to is there every time. Then I can see Dr. Bhanu Swaraj. Then Lina is there. Yes. Then I can see Arifur Rahman. But I don't know whether this is a boy or a girl or a man or a woman. But people are joining in. Let them join in Aram Sen. All those who are already here, some of you can start some watch parties. This is what I learned from the younger generation. Sir, why don't you tell everybody to start watch parties? So that if 100 people start a watch party, the program can reach 10,000 people faster. So I said, I am not that generation man, so I don't know all about this thing. I know only one thing. If the program is good, it will be anyway watched by many, many, many people. And those who don't watch, they are unfortunate, not me. Simple. Right? So be positive in life. Good. So you will be wondering, what am I doing in a women's dentist program and how come this all happened? So there are two reasons why am I here today. One big reason is for the last almost 8 to 10 years, I have been taking this program, life as a BDS, life as a MDS, life after 10 and 25 years in practice. I have been talking about these programs live in front of our audiences, as well as I have been talking about parts of this program in my 3-day course and in my Thane clinic and in my iCode office in Gurgaon and other places wherever I take a program. And as we all know, 80% dentists in India are women dentists. And in our course also, normally the ratio is out of every 12 dentists, there are almost 8 or 9 women dentists and 3 or 4 male dentists. And then because I talk all these along with the regular crown and bridge, porcelain veneer, digital smile design, I am talking about mother-in-law, I am talking about why not marry a dentist, I am talking about, you know, so many other small things that most women get, probably they feel after a day's one first take the course ends, or the second day, they definitely feel that probably this man is talking some sense and I need to ask him certain things which have been troubling me. And then they keep asking this question. So when it all started, probably I never had an answer for everything. And of course, somehow it just comes in my brain. And I started realizing that my suggestions, my tips, my answers are working in favor of the person the lady who is asking me these questions. And that was amazing. And that gave me confidence in life to talk openly about mother-in-law in front of an audience, say, of 1,200 or any size like that also, where I could face criticism from the audience itself. Somebody may get angry in the audience, but I realized that if I lace humor along with these things, most people could digest what I'm saying. And if they thought about what I was talking about, the son's mother and the woman's mother-in-law, they could connect with that concept. But this was on an audience basis. And then I do this 5 programs on webinars on WDA. And one of the panelists who is present in front of us now is Dr. Samita Zunzar Rao Patil. What a surname. I love that Zunzar Rao in between. Aisa lagta, you know, somebody has come today on our panel. Yes, I wanted you to type that Samita in between. So Samita is that one woman dentist in India who actually sent me a message asking a question. And after I answered her question on WhatsApp after, I think, last Sunday's program, she actually sent me a message asking me, can you have a program on these issues on the WDA platform? And I was not taken aback, but I said, "Arey, that's a great thing to do. Probably I should exploit this opportunity." So I told her, wait, let me ask WDA. And I sent a message to Abhishek and Anand and to take their permission. Can we have like this? I'm sure Abhishek and Anand have the same issues in their lives, even if they are men, because if the woman of the house is affected, the men are affected too. And Abhishek to instantly said, ah, sir, done. You know, Anand said, "Haan, sir, aap jo aap kuch bhi bolo to WTA pe rakhenge." And that was so sweet of Anand, you know. I swear it. I mean, I don't mind. I first of all, I want to ask you, can I join WTA like you young guys are there? Can I take this young boy? I'll remove my coat if you want. I will look really younger, you know. And I will dive this if you want, make it nice and black.
Sir, it would be our honor.
I'm loving working with you guys, sincerely. And selfless working without any commercial angle, that's drawing my attention even much better way. I'm simply loving this. Trust me, Anand, today I'm telling you, I have lots of offers for paid webinars. Okay, from small payments to large payments, but I have not taken a single offer, because I don't think in front of WDA, those offers are nothing. You know, nothing.
Thanks a lot, sir.
In lakhs, which I am getting, which I can reach, you know, to so many people in such a short time. So I am loving it, and I would advise many senior dentists or junior, whoever is a speaker, to come forward on WDA platform and do some kind of presentation. It would be really nice. Chalo, so let's go on to today's topic, and we will now. We have planned it in a different way. We have not rehearsed the program. Okay, viewers? So we have not rehearsed the program, though these ladies sitting in front of me, they are from different parts of India. They all connected me on WhatsApp with their problems and their issues and their dilemmas in life. And of course, there are many more who contacted me on my WhatsApp and my Facebook Messenger. But these are the four who were bold enough when I gave them a suggestion that, Samita, since you are wanting me on this program, why don't you join the program on the panel? And she, I can't, you know. When I spoke to Kanwar is shivering just now. Kanwar shakes slightly, so we can come to know that you're really afraid today, you know. And so she said, I'm so afraid. It's my first time in life on that too, on a webinar, that too, on a World Dental Association platform. And these are real people, you know, Dr. Parisha, the last entry, these are the real people who actually sent me questions. So I thought I should not be answering their questions on their WhatsApp also, though I gave a trailer of answering one or two, that's it. But I told them, hold on to your questions and ask me directly on this day. There is one more thing in today's program. If there is anybody in the audience who is writing questions in the comments, and if you wish to join the program, please type your mobile number or your email ID in the comments box, and Dr. Abhishek or Dr. Anand will immediately contact you, send you the StreamYard software link. You just need to open your laptop and instantly connect on that link, and you can be in front of everybody just now. Okay? Don't have any fear. There is nothing like that. And of course, if you have any personal question which you don't want to reveal, that's your question, where there are ways to ask such a question, that one of my friend, when she realized that I am on the panel today, she has sent me this question. Okay, so be smart enough to ask a personal question in such a way. Okay, no questions regarding about your marriage. Okay, because I am not a marriage counselor and I don't wish to behave like one. I am not even a counselor for that matter. So keep those kind of questions away, because yesterday evening I had a long conversation with one dentist, and I actually, you know, told that dentist that this is going now very, very personal. I think you need to meet a marriage counselor and you need to sit with your family and talk this out, because this is going now in the wrong direction. Correct? So I may be versatile, but I am not so versatile. Okay, and you don't wish to enter in an arena where I am not, I know nothing about it. So welcome everybody again, and let's have some fun. And I give it, I think, who is starting? Sayogita, you are starting the evening for everybody.
Yes, sir.
So the DSD woman of India,
yes,
is starting the program for all the women.
Oh, thank you, sir. Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you. First of all, thank you from all of us, from all the women dentists in India for answering these questions. And it will be helpful for others who are entering into the field or just entered or in middle or just completed everything. So I would like to start with when we enter into BDS, like most of the women dentists who enter are under parental pressure who enter. Like the parents say, ki, oh, engineering you will go and later on you won't find a boy who will roam about with you. Or and then they enter into, try to enter into MBBS, but nevertheless, they are not able to enter, they enter into BDS. And then parents will say, ki, okay, now you need to marry a good boy because you get a tag of doctor and then you can marry a suitable prospect. And once they get married, they don't practice at all. Like 50% of females, even my friends, they don't practice. And even if they practice, they are like part-time, or if children are not well, they won't go, or whatever. There are many hurdles which come across. So how do you change the mindset from beforehand? Like once you enter also, or people who are there, I'm asking in on behalf of people who are in internship now. Like they are into dilemma whether to go for MDS or whether they should enter practice, whether they should do a locum.
Started with BDS and you started with 12th standard and you actually to having children also to there, you know.
I know, sir. Okay.
Everybody,
thank you,
please
sir.
Keep your question very short. If there are four things in one question, ask one by one. Okay, because I am not an intelligent guy, I am not a genius, I am an average. I can remember only one thing at one time. Okay. And one disclaimer for all of you again, all what I say, it is out of my personal experiences in life. It is out of my friends and family experiences, what I have seen in life. It is all about my dentist friends, colleagues, my course participants' lives. It is a mixture of so many things. I may certain things which may hurt somebody's feelings, but trust me, I don't intend to do it at all. Some of my comments, some of the dynamic women dentists would find feminist, but then don't worry, there would be some comments of some women which we men don't complain, but I can definitely use a word today, melinist. If such a word does not exist, make it exist from today in the World Dictionary. Okay, so don't feel bad about anything. Okay, so let's go. And I think what Sanyogita was trying to ask, what I gather from her question is, yes, I have asked this to many young girls who have come for my course, not even young girls, even dentists who are 10 years into dentistry or are presently housewives because of kids and who rejoin dentistry and then come to my program to learn again or relearn again. When I have asked them, why did you become a dentist? And some of them who were really frank about it actually have told me that, sir, we wanted to be something else only in life. But our parents thought that if we become a doctor, it doesn't mind which doctor, we would get a prospective husband who's, you know. And whenever I hear such a statement from a lady's mouth, I feel horrible, actually speaking. And I always, if some of the women who have asked me this question, and if you are attending today, and if you remember my answer, I go crazy. I answer, you need to sit with your parents and talk to them. Are you actually trying to sell me today? Are you making me a doctor to sell me in the marriage market? How many of you women have spoken like this to your parents? Why can't you have such conversations with your parents? You need to have such conversations with your parents, you know, because this is sad. This is sad, you know, getting into the world of medical just to get married is crazy. It's simply crazy, you know. It is something which is a complete no-no from my side. So a small message to your parents, or to now you as parents, because your children will grow up in future. You may not be able to change the past, but I guess for the future, for your children at least, please do not pass on this nonsense thing about you need to become this to get this man in life or this, you know, type of boy in life. I think that's ridiculous. I'm feeling ashamed when some parent would say like this also. So Sayogita, that part is your part one of your question can answer, right? And slowly then you moved on to directly having into, you know, my friend into there. And I think the answer for all what you asked is going to be the same.
Yes. So, sir, I want. Yes. Now I wanted you to address the interns or the present people who have just passed out of internship, women dentists, that they should have a mind of their own and understand the difference what parents have been teaching and what we should go, how to go about as a career.
So to begin with, first of all, take a pencil and a paper as usual in my programs and write down to be a dentist. 98% of answers I know, 98% of dentists in India, male and female, never wanted to be dentists. Except 2%, 1% is whose parents are dentists and 1% are normally women who undergo orthodontic treatment as a child and they get infatuated by that orthodontist and, you know, orthodontists are handsome and then they dream long-term relationship with an orthodontist because you go 8 standard, 9 standard, some of you even 10 standard, and that's the time when hormonal changes are happening and this man is handsome, he comes and hugs you almost every 3 weeks for 2 years and then you decide I want to be a dentist, you know. So those class of women who are dentists today, you keep aside. Those whose parents are dentists, let's keep aside. 98% you never wanted to be dentist, correct? So yes, we all never wanted to be dentists. So now after you pass out dentistry, at least now in this journey, since you have already become a doctor, a dentist, you need to make a call. Should I switch my career now at least, which you should have done in first year of dentistry after joining and realizing that I am not fit for this line. You should have done that time. None of us got to do it in India. So we continue with the program. Some of us start liking it. Some of us still become pass out. But take a call at least after passing BDS that are you fit for it? If not,
yes.
I mean, later on becoming a housewife, yes, becoming a housewife, yes. One thing I can say as a male dentist, you are doing a tremendous social service for male dentists, you know. By becoming a housewife, you're reducing at least 50% of competition in the field because you're not starting your practice. So there are lesser number of clinics. Because 80 women dentists decide to start practice, there'll be 50 new clinics every college,
so
a lot of competition for. So I'm grateful for that. But on the other end, what I feel is, well, you wasted somebody's seat. You could have given that seat to some, you know, person or some boy who could have been a dentist today and who could have started his own practice or, you know, used the knowledge and the skill acquired in those 4 years and 1 year at internship and paid respect to the teachers. Of course, that does not mean that, you know, you could always switch professions, but at least, I mean, in today's world, don't be a housewife. It's out of question. You have to be something in today's world. You have to stand on your own feet. I will come slowly in my further answers. You know, this nonsense of only why should men stand on their own feet to be a female in their life is the most ridiculous thing in this world. So I'll answer that separately.
Yes, I invite Dr. Samida to ask the next question, please.
Good. Thank you, Samida. This is too complicated in asking questions. She is the genius type. So she should make her question complicated. Samida is very simple. See how she will start.
Thank you, sir, and thank you, WDA, for this session. It was wonderful and made up the time for all the female dentists. And I'll continue with what Dr. Sanyogita had asked. After making the decision that you have completed your BDS, one female dentist should start immediately with a clinic or not, because always there's a parental pressure that get married and then you can start wherever you get married because the city changes, the location changes. But again, that decision making depends on the in-laws in which house she gets married. So how to handle this? Because the decision never depends on her. It depends on, again, the other family. So if you can just put light on this.
Is there any bold woman, if there is one watching today, can you put it on the in the comment box that I am bold? Let me see at least one or two messages which say, yes, I am bold. No, I can't see. So there is nobody who is bold enough. Sayogita, tu chodke, panel dentist not allowed. So bold enough. I want one more comment at least that I am bold enough. Yes. If you are bold enough. Yes, I am. Pooja Kamdar. Yes, Pooja. I like that. Alright, let's today change the trend in the world completely. Let's start one movement today. Okay. Where women stop going to men's houses after marriage. Let's start a new movement. Why can't men go to women's house after marriage? I am ready. I was always ready in life for this. What is this nonsense? I don't understand that only the woman has to. I think most women will love this sentence of mine. If you love it, please write in the comments box. We love it. We love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Okay. Oh, yes. Why not? है ना? So, ये सारा system है ना society का बड़ा बेकार है. And there is nobody in this world who is ready to change it. I mean, there are so many so-called women's lobbies in India also, and every news channel and so many women, big ladies, you know, of India, they come on television channels to talk about women power and all. I never hear this one thing from these women that they need this one basic change we need to do in life. Right? So now, since you said bold Pooja Kamdar, at least I would, if you are not married, I would like you to start the change. If not, at least do the change in your children's life. If you have daughters, anybody of you, my dear panelists, or anybody is listening, all those who are listening to me today, why can't we have a mindset change in this direction itself? I'm loving this expression on Payal's face. You know, the way Payal is looking, Hare Bapre, pehle malum hota to, hai na? I'm loving it, yes. Yeah, it's a true thing here. It is 2020 now. We need to change certain things. So going back on to Samida's question, Samida actually answered the question. You know what she said? After BDS, if a lady wants to start her own practice, what does she do? Should she start her clinic immediately or what should she do? And of course, till the time the trend in the world is the girl goes to the boy's house after marriage. Of course, the answer is yes, you will not start any clinic. Reason is, if you start a clinic, suppose in Latur, and later on, suppose you get married into Pune, what happens to your 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, 5 year practice? You wind it up. Oh my God, that's so difficult. So the obvious answer is, till you get married, you have to work with somebody as an associate dentist or in a hospital or at a charity or somewhere and do time pass of life, you know, educate yourselves, gather knowledge, gather more skill, and then wait for that D-Day, the doom day, marriage. The D come doom day. The D ka full form is doom day. So what we say, the D day is actually marriage, is also could be a doom day for most of us. Huh? And many of us, though it's a happy doom day, no problem. Because there are more dooms in life than only D's. And you can actually, you can learn to negotiate all these dooms in life very nicely in your life. No problem. Anyway, so start your clinic only after marriage. There is no reason to start it before unless the boy decides to come and stay at your place. That's the most amazing thing that can happen. And it has multiple advantages. I will talk about this again when we come on. If there is a question on mother-in-law relationship, I will come on this again. But what was your, anything else, Amida, you had asked in that same question?
No, again, the decision making depends upon the in-laws. Whether to start a clinic or not.
The in-laws. Great. So I think these are conversations which your family needs to have in an arranged marriage with the boy's family before marriage, especially for those women who are career oriented, who wish to start their own practice, who wish to stand on their own feet, who wish to have their own identity in life, who wish to have their own name and fame in life. All such women, if you are in arranged marriage, it is high time you discussed all with your parents, and your parents along with you discussed with the boy and the boy's parent before the engagement. For the love marriage guys, it's fun, because love marriage is a blind procedure between a boy and a girl, which happens in India by just eye contact. Then there is a chemical locha. Hindi pictures have depicted it so beautifully since I was a small child. Earlier days, a boy and a girl used to hit in a college corridor and books used to fall down. And while lifting up the books, the eye contact and chemical locha happened. Slowly things changed, but today also, the way it is shown on movies is beautiful, correct? For those who are in love marriage, or say people like me, who have no option to discuss with your in-laws all these issues, correct? Then you have your partner who I think loves you, and you need to sit with him, take him in confidence and discuss with him. I can understand not many men would be considerate about this. I can talk about that also in a short thing. That's probably because, welcome, my wife is here at the right time. That's probably because men have been nurtured in this country and the society and all over the world, especially by our parents, especially our mother and father, in a such a way since childhood that a boy is a boy, this is his duties, and a girl is a girl, this is his duty. And I think this is the biggest problem area of our life. We say that we have treated our son and daughter equally in life, but actually none of the parents are doing it properly, equally. We just say it. I think this is the, again what we I say, we need to change at grassroots level, and we have to inculcate all these things into our son or daughter as they are growing up. You know, example I can give tomorrow, today, suppose you, these four panelists sitting in front of me with your four husbands, you shifted or migrated to, suppose after BDS, and your husband could be a dentist or non-dentist, and you migrated to a country like America, where there is a no concept of, say, servants, unless you are super rich, and you have to manage everything in life. I am sure Indian men who don't do anything in the kitchen in India, who have never taken a broomstick in India to clean their house, I think behave in a much better way when they are with their wife in America. They manage the house with almost 50-50 responsibility. So these are the same men who would have stayed back in India, would not have done anything out of this. Trust me on this one. Correct? There is enough, so much to learn from these countries also. I think so. I can answer it in a simple way. We need to do a lot of working from our parenthood to begin with itself. Samida, you can proceed. I know you have a list of questions. Some of them I hope are not your questions, and you are passing on to by saying it's...
If anybody
who is listening to me, hi Priya. Priya, if you want to ask anything and you want to protect your marriage also, then see that you ask a question saying that one of my friend has sent me this question to ask you, and I will understand, okay? No, Priya has already communicated with me, and I told her I'll answer your question live on that day. But chalo, Samida, anything else? Or Sayogita, anything else?
I can just continue with this question. After that, then the biggest challenge which we female dentists face is to be a hands-on dentist or a hands-on wife, mother or both. How to tackle this?
Sai, take out your pen and paper and write down what you are. Panelists, write down. You also need to write down. What are you out of these four things? Are you a dynamic woman? Are you a strong woman? Are you a emotional, sentimental woman? Or are you a calm woman? What four out of this you are? You can have two traits at least out of this. That's no problem. But remember, out of the two traits, you need to circle the one which you are dominant. Okay? So I don't remember who had asked me this question. I think, Priya, that was you who had asked me this question. And Priya ended up saying, I am emotional. And then I said, I think there could be some other. Or she only answered, no, I am dynamic. And I said, no, what is dominant? And I will tell you today, because I have traveled with Priya in a train from Latur to Mumbai, so I can tell what she is. She is a dynamic woman. There is no question. She has 25% emotional part to her, but she is 75% dynamic. Priya will agree. And I know it, the way you conduct your life, you are a dynamic woman. Okay. So now this answer to the Samida's question depends upon what type of personality, first of all, you are. Okay. My take on personalities, we are actually born with these personalities. We cannot change our personalities. Okay. So I don't think if you are emotional in life and you join a course of personality development and overnight you will become a dynamic personality, I doubt you will not. Okay, I don't think so. This is, we are literally born with it. It is in our DNA. It is probably passed to us through, God knows. I am not a researcher, but I would advise Rajiv Chitgopi, somebody like him, to do some good research on these things also. A dynamic lady, if you are a dynamic lady, profession, husband, mother-in-law, children, what is the issue? Huh? I don't see any issue. Let's take the lady who leads PepsiCo company. I think Mrs. Noori, right? Okay. I mean, take that lady here. Take that lady. I mean, take even our, who is leading Colgate in India? Who is leading Colgate in India? I know I would like to see other panelists' faces also. Ananda, that's better. Who is leading Dr. Swapna? Yes, I think dynamic lady. These ladies or these type of women or men can manage everything in life. You know, so there is a method to manage everything in life. How do you manage a clinic? Well, you manage your clinic by having the adequate staff for your clinic. Correct? Yes. You manage your husband by having a conversation with him before marriage, during marriage, whole life, and knowing, let him know that you are a dynamic. And actually, probably he liked you for that reason because you are dynamic. But you would actually never explored this conversation with your husband, you know? So he should know it. And that means once he knows it, and if you are dynamic, I'm sure you will manage him, you know, without any issue. A mother-in-law, a dynamic woman will smartly manage her mother-in-law without any issue. She will see that she buys occasional Cadbury chocolate for her mother-in-law, stand in the balcony like they show in the advertisement, and she will settle her issues with the mother-in-law beautifully without involving the husband and the father-in-law. Correct? And the dynamic lady will easily manage 2-3 children by having nice servants or maids in the house. She will have no issues in life. Problem starts when we go on to the other stripe of the spectrum, the emotional woman. A dominant emotional woman has only one thing to do in life, to crib, crib and crib. Correct? Now, crib is the wrong word actually, because you are made like that. So people around you need to understand that, which is an impossible task for everybody, because and it's always opposite attracts. So an emotional woman will never attract probably an emotional man, because if both husband and wife are emotional, why am I alone on the this thing? Because I'm not enjoying when I'm alone. I feel I'm talking to a dead wall, you know. I like this expression on Kanwar's face, you know, when she does this. And I like Sayogita's big white DSG smile. And, you know, I like Samida slyly smiling behind. I like that. So emotional women, you know, you are made like that. So accept it. You can't be dynamic. So why crib? You will have to, in that, I cannot use a wrong word, sacrifice, because that's a very wrong and a bad word according to me. You don't have to sacrifice anything in life, nor you have to feel like that in life. Be happy with your personality because you are emotional, you know. Enjoy that personality, because that is one personality will get capture people to you more than the strong and probably the calm people. Use that to your advantage. Try to do whatever best. Little practice, probably, you know, children, little, you could do small things. Need not be very dynamic. you don't look at dynamic people because you can't become like them. Then, because if you look at dynamic people, you will get frustrated in life. See how my college friend Sayogita is doing so well today. And I am a housewife doing chapatis at home and managing 3 children and a diabetic, irritating mother-in-law and a buzzard husband. And this is typical of that lady, which can happen, you know. So don't look at Sayogita. There is no need to look at a dynamic person because I feel you cannot change too much. So try to find out a way in your life how happy you can be and negotiate things around these people beautifully. In fact, you have the power of being emotional, which according to me is the best example I can give about myself. I am extremely dynamic on one side and I am extremely dynamic on and extremely emotional on one side. In fact, the ratio in my life is I am 50% or 51% emotional and 49% dynamic. And that is seen in my lectures because I always people say, sir, aap jo bhi bolte ho, dil se bolte ho, direct bolte ho, bina dar ke bolte ho. दिल से जो बोलता हूं वो मेरा इमोशनल पार्ट है, बिना डर के बोलता हूं ये मेरा डायनामिक पार्ट है. सी हाउ दीज टू थिंग्स गो हैंड इन हैंड ऑल्सो. ओके, अदर पीपल हु आर काम आर द बेस्ट बिकॉज फॉर देम इट डजंट मैटर एट ऑल वेदर दे सिट एट होम और वेदर दे वर्क. दे आर आई थिंक द स्मार्टेस्ट एंड द कूलेस्ट वुमेन यू कैन फाइंड और द स्मार्टेस्ट मैन. द मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल डेंटिस्ट और अ डॉक्टर इज ए पर्सन हु इज काम. Patients love calm doctors because they have only one thing to say in life, main hoon na. And this main hoon na is so comforting from a woman's voice or from a man's voice. You know, even children would be happy if you say to your child, main hoon na beta. Mother-in-law will be happy when you say, main hoon na. You know, husband to will be super happy if you say, main hoon na. Husband's best friends, you know, others' husbands will be even more happy if you tell them, main hoon na. So my huna works, I think, with the emotional guys. Okay. So answer to that again, it depends upon what type of your personality is. According to that, design your life around it. Do not try to change yourselves because a change is not possible. Though the world says that over time we can change. Yes, we can adapt new things out of bad experiences. Then we say, no, this doesn't work. Is better. But our basic nature, I don't think ever changes in life. If I am wrong, somebody can correct me in the comments box or on my WhatsApp later on. Good. Anything else?
So there is question from crowd. Can I take up that? Yeah.
Yeah. So, just it's in sequence.
No. They are up and down.
Finish the panelist first.
Yeah. Okay. Over to Dr. Payal.
Payal, yes. You have to unmute yourself.
Hello. Yes. Hi, sir.
Hi.
I just want to know, just give me a few tips how to manage the clinic with kids and as if like no one at home also to take care of kids. Other than maids, because always we can't depend on maids for everything. So I just want few tips to manage kids with family.
So the answer, second answer I'll give you. Think you are in the United States today with your husband and kids. Okay. And 6 months your mother-in-law comes and 6 months your own mother comes and they manage the kids.
Yeah.
Okay. The other way, suppose you don't have a mother-in-law and you don't have a mother.
Yeah. Correct? We don't have anything, no one at home, and we need to manage both the clinic.
So in that situation, how would you would have managed in America? So the answer is very obvious. You gave the answer. The answer is, yes, all those working women, correct, will have to utilize the maid service or a, what do you say, creche, right? Yes, you will have to use that service if you want to be in the career also and you want to be in the have a child also, correct? And you need to do everything. You have to take a service of either a maid or a maid and a creche or a neighbor or auntie or somebody or one more option. You need to distribute the time between yourselves and your spouse. So when you are at home, he is at work. When he is at home, you are at work. Easily possible if your husband is a dentist husband, or easily possible if your husband is a doctor husband, MBBS side or anything. Easily possible if your husband has a business or a shop owner or anything. Any husband is with any partner, this is possible. Who that partner has a staff to run his thing, you know. If the partner also has a staff to run his profession and staff to run his business and staff to run his shop, for those many hours, I'm sure your husband can come home, correct? And the staff can run his business and you can go to your practice and vice versa. It's easily possible. I think we all, again, I have to say that we all need to work at parent level. So all those women and men who are listening to me, Hetal and Nigam, I saw your names. It is all about us, not about our children, I suppose, you know. We need to see that the next generation, means your children, are nurtured only in this manner, that right from young age, they know that mommy likes to work, daddy likes to work. We are taken care by this auntie who is not my relative, but is like my relative, correct? But mommy and daddy still love us. No problems on that. You know? I think we need to. Because in today's world, at least that's what I have told my daughters in life. I have two daughters. You have to stand on your own feet. There is no way in life that you will become a housewife. And if you ever have to become a housewife, that will be a prudent decision of your life. But see that you have enough qualification in life so that you can make a comeback in life. Tomorrow, what happens if the husband leaves you or you leave the husband? Correct? What happens? There is no guarantee in today's world that nobody will divorce. There is no guarantee that in today's world that this cannot happen after even 10 years of marriage. There is no guarantee at all. Correct? So anything can happen. So all women dentists, or all women, I guess, need to stand on their own feet for sure. Either you have your own clinic or you work with somebody, you know, or just work to keep your brain busy, because that way at least you will not become a gossip queen, which I see on WhatsApp groups. Even though we dentists are working, there are many gossip queens on WhatsApp group, and they quickly gossip. Tere ko malum hai isko COVID-19 positive nikla. I mean, there is no need to do all that, you know, unless it's the person himself. I am COVID-19 positive. Why do you want to start the gossip around? Of course, men also do it, but don't do. So I think empty brain, empty time is more horrible. And that's the reason why this question is actually. Because you are realizing that on one side I wish to work, but on the other side life is taking its toll on me. Right? Also, we will come to a point when some of you ask a question as to men cannot deliver. The most hilarious, I think, point in my lecture is the fun part of my lecture is men cannot deliver. So one day when I was talking, men cannot deliver, a male dentist got angry and he actually stood up in my lecture and said, "What nonsense, men cannot deliver. I know lots of successful dentists, including me." And I said, "My dear friend, you got it wrong. I was talking about delivering a baby. Men cannot deliver a baby. This is something nature has made. And I don't think humans have the capacity to change this concept for another 100 years at least, correct? So we'll talk about that. What do you do then, correct? Good. So Payal, yes, ask anything, or if the question is still incomplete, ask the balance part also.
I just want to know that the women also has to do a general practice, or she should be more, do something in something speciality.
Tell me one
thing. If she's BDS.
Tell me one thing. Thank you for clearing it. Let me start with a simple thing. Suppose if anybody of you is MDS, anybody is MDS out of you four? Out of the panel, anybody who is MDS? No, we did not have anybody as a panel on MDS. Okay, good. So for a moment, let me say Sanyogita is an MDS. Okay? Chalo. Suppose Sanyogita was an orthodontist today. Correct? That means Sayogita or any woman or any male dentist to spend additional 3 years in education, additional 3 years of life, 3 years of parents' money, 3 years of energy, 3 years of efforts in life, and after becoming an MDS in any subject, and on top of that in a subject like say orthodontist, if you're going to sit at home after that, what can I say? I'm feeling miserable for all of you, all those who are doing this. You have to utilize your degree. You have to find a way out in life. You have to talk to your husbands. You have to talk to your in-laws. You have to talk to your own family. You should have taken these decisions right after becoming an MDS. You should have been a little smarter before falling in love also. You know, these days, wo book dhakka laga aur aankhon mein aankh ishq ho gaya and pyar ho gaya. I don't think even women follow that much in these days. I think in that love marriage also, you need to be a person who smartly falls in love. You know, in earlier days, maybe they showed in Hindi movies that women saw the money of that man and fell in love. And that's how they used to show, you know, in old Hindi movies. Today, I think we need to fall in love with a man who is broad-minded, who you think in life would give you this opportunity to work, who would be proud of you working or anything like that, you know. So Meenakshi walks in and is looking at me, because I will talk about myself little later, you know, how a huge change has happened in me over the years, because I also have been nurtured the same way like any other Indian boy or a man, you know. So how this journey and how my change also happened, and thanks to all women around me whom I have been looking since when I started understanding all these things. Okay, good. So if you are a BDS, what do you do? First of all, the problem part of our country is our MDS men and women are doing BDS giri. I don't understand only this concept. I think I spoke enough about this in Life After MDS program. If you have not heard any of my three of programs, Life as a BDS, Life as an MDS, and Life After 10 and 25 Years in Practice, they are all on my website, www.drrajivverma.com, or they are on WDA platform. Please go and watch all the three series, and they have to be watched by everybody. For BDS, you need to watch even the MDS and 10 to 15 years, and for 10 to 15 years, you need to watch BDS and MDS, okay? The biggest mistake everybody is doing is you are doing MDS and then you are not utilizing the knowledge you acquired in MDS. I mean, that's a disrespect to your degree, first of all. Practicing BDS giri after becoming an orthodontist, after becoming prosthodontist, after becoming maxillofacial surgeon, after becoming periodontist. Why do you want to practice general dentistry? Why can't you believe in your degree? Why can't you believe in yourselves? Why can't you believe in your teachers? It's a disrespect not only to your degree, it's a disrespect to your teachers who taught you for 3 years. So when I spoke last time, one doctor sent me a message on WhatsApp saying, sir, but my teacher hi MDS hai, lekin wo bhi khud bhi sham ko general practice karta hai. Oh my God, I have nothing to say about such teachers. I can only say one thing now, that this is money, money, money. My India is only oriented behind and around money. All those doctors who are MDS, please believe in your degree, believe in yourselves, and only have a practice which is only MDS practice. Exclusive specialization. In fact, 5 years into life, by the time you are 32 years old, you should be a super specialist like Dr. Sayogita, who is a DSD specialist of India, and her husband Avinash, who is a TMD specialist of India. Correct? I am doubtful whether Sayogita is 32. I think she is 40 ke aspas. But I want 42. You to achieve 42. So I wanted Sayogita, the next generation, to achieve this between 32 and 35. Okay? Not even wait 42. Why? Why waste your knowledge? Understood? So now who stops you from, for BDS, from going on to that path? Why can't a BDS undertake a program like say what Sayogita did? She did a program of digital smile design with Christian Coachman once. Then she did it with me. Then she's been doing the DST program continuously. She followed the five guru journey. In between, Sayogita did a Kulmao 3F program also, if I remember. And she did the DDM to put on the little business sense and soft skills into the profession. She completed her five guru concept. And today, looking at her, she looks like a super professional dentist. That coat what she is wearing is a Gucci one, I think so. The t-shirt what she is wearing is a branded one. The lipstick what she is wearing is like also a super branded product, correct? All this has come thanks to this. Otherwise, what Sayogita would have been doing is just general dentistry till now. She would be still doing a root canal treatment for 2,000 rupees and a crown for 3,500 and a scaling for 800 and an extraction for 300. And I can go and on. So who stops BDS from growing up in life? So why can't all women acquire knowledge, acquire skill? We may not get a degree of an MDS in life. We may not become a dentist on paper, but at least you can become a prosto-dentist, a ortho-dentist, a endo-dentist. You know, find that one or two subjects what you really love and like in life. We know that we never wanted to be dentists, but now that you are married to dentistry, please fall in love with dentistry. I am repeating all what I am already spoken in my previous programs on WD, but I have to repeat it because they make sense even for women dentists. Right? So whether you are a BDS, whether you are an MDS, the path ahead is a five guru mantra. And five guru mantra ideally only in one subject which you love. Okay, and if you can have a practice with two or three dental chairs with exclusive what you do and have patients on all three dental chairs for your DSD or for your TMD or for your ortho or for your only implant practice, there is no need to do anything else in dentistry. There is no need to just refer patients to other dentists, do social service, benefit other professionals around you. Why not think big? Because this way you can achieve big things in life. Big name, big fame, big money. Oh, so when I talk about big money, I will add one thing before I forget. Women dentists, remember one thing in our country, or I think globally. Men in the world are not yet nurtured to digest one fact. That a woman can earn more than men. So women dentists, remember, I know some women dentists who have gone through a divorce or almost on a verge of a divorce and have confessed with me in my courses that, sir, I earn more than my husband and now our marriage is in trouble. When I am married to him, he was earning and I had no clinic, but later on I started my own clinic and today I am earning 10 lakhs a month and my husband is only earning 3-4 lakhs a month. And sir, this is a big, big problem of my life. And what do I do about it? Oh my God. Men in India just cannot digest this fact. Okay? Bol, Samida, I'll come to this again. Bol.
To the discussion, I just came, like I just thought of this. If for some reason one cannot specialize in a particular subject, can a female dentist think of being a female dentist, like in your language you say, especially for women, like women patients only? Can she think on this?
Of course. Yes, why not? But I have a small take here. A woman dentist should ideally only start a clinic to treat men patients. I'll prove it. If you take a survey and ask all the women you know in life, are they comfortable going to a male gynecologist or a female gynecologist for their delivery? And trust me, in India today also, most women are more confident of going to a male gynecologist than a female gynecologist. Can you believe that?
No.
You believe that? Hey, do a survey. I have done a survey, okay. So I know it. I've asked so many women, and it is a fact. It is a fact. Okay. So that way. So if that is for the other end of the body, I think for this end, you should start only a clinic for men. And you would be the most amazing practice. I mean, that should not be because of you, woman, that the practice should run. No. The practice should run because of your professional approach, because of your skill, because of your dynamic nature. Take to advantage that, okay? But why can't a woman start a geriatric dental clinic? Why can't a woman dentist like Dr. Meenakshi Kher start only a pedo center? Why can't a woman orthodontist? Why can't a woman BDS dentist literally achieves mastery in prosthetic, calls herself a prosthodontist verbally, not on a visiting card, you know, but exclusive prosthetic work in practice, and rest everything is done by husband dentist, or everything done by consultants coming to practice, or all other things what she does not do, she can refer it to somebody. Yes, why not? Why a difference of gender? I don't think it works here. Me, men and women are equal, I think, here. There is nothing what men can do, women cannot do. I mean, look at Sayogita's body strength. She can easily remove and extract a upper 7, correct? Yes, easily. So there is nothing like that, you know. Correct? Yes or no, Sayogita?
Yes.
Then, so yes. She's better than male dentist. I can never, you know, hang on to upper 7. I will always remove
7. 8 also, sir, no problem.
Enough, yeah. So it's all about you. Yes, Samita, yes. Bolo. Samita, any question? Nahi? Tera ho gaya? Payal, any question?
I'll no, come, sir, afterwards. I'll ask special progress. Yes.
Let's go to Dr. Kanwar. She's really waiting, stressed, shivering, sweating.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for allowing me to be the part of this. And I should take with my questions. Initially, my first query is under judging a female dentist. I've seen it a lot.
Pardon?
Under judging a female dentist.
Okay.
Yes. I don't know the other females must have gone through this or not, but at some part of time, we usually feel this. Because I feel this whenever my husband is not in the clinic, usually patients ask, Dr. Saab nahi hai kya? And I ask myself, I'm not the Dr. Saab. I'm just a madam for them and my husband is Dr. Saab for them. So what's your take on this thing?
How many of you listening to her connect with her? Can I have some comments which say yes, we connect? Yes, we connect. Dr. Peera Chandra, Upma Nara.
I also connect, sir.
Neelam, Dr. Jyoti Gar, Dr. Apeksha, anybody of you connect with her? Please say connect. Ek aur likha, husband marega, sir. वो जमाना गया है उसका हस्बैंड मारेगा ऐसा कुछ रहेगा घर में एक पोस्टर लगा दे या यू जॉइन सम वुमेन्स एसोसिएशन यू नो एंड जस्ट बी अ मेंबर ऑफ दैट कोई हस्बैंड कुछ मारने का सवाल भी पैदा नहीं होगा है ना बोलने का भी सोचेगा भी नहीं अपने दिमाग में तो यू नो सो आई थिंक वी नीड टू चेंज अ लॉट कनेक्ट ओह माय गॉड एवरीबॉडी इज कनेक्टिंग टू यू कन्वर यू आर द रॉक स्टार ऑफ टुडे Do you know? So friends, I have to share with you one thing. These panelists in which are front of me, of course, including Sayogita. I mean, Sayogita I know, but I don't know the Zunzar Raos at all. I don't know Payal at all. I don't know Kanwar at all. And they trusted me. They sent me a message with questions and I invited them to be live. And they had apprehension. But I think we all need to clap for them, especially for Kanwar, because it's her first time on any screen in her life.
Yes, sir.
Kanwar,
yes.
I think you are a strong woman. Strong woman. You are not emotional. You may have a quality of a calm woman, but you are not dynamic. But you are definitely dominant, strong woman. And that strength of yours actually made you come today live. And of course, me telling you, kya hoga maximum, pasina niklega, aisa aisa karenge, gala sukhega, pani piyenge.
Yes, sir.
Na? So, WBA, have a new speaker on your platform, Kanwar Malik would be the next webinar after 10 days from now on any beautiful topic. It may be cooking, it may be how to look after children, or you need maybe how to train husbands. She is the best one to talk. Good. So Kanwar, there are questions. Rajiv Verma has gone through the same journey in life. My wife, Dr. Meenakshi, is an endodontist. She is a MDS, I am a BDS. वहीं से प्रॉब्लम स्टार्ट हुआ था शादी के पहले से ही मदर इन लॉ के साइड से मेरे मदर इन लॉ के साइड से ना वो तो मैंने मैनेज कर लिया था है ना बिकॉज लव के सामने एवरीथिंग गोज ब्लाइंड करेक्ट गुड आई हैव फेस द सेम इशू इन लाइफ द बिग डिफरेंस बिटवीन मी एंड माय वाइफ मीनाक्षी वाज द हाइट डिफरेंस द सेकंड बिग डिफरेंस वाज स्टेचर आई वाज टॉल आई वाज आई लुक्ड बिगर She looked petite. She still looks like a Barbie doll.
Yeah.
Whenever we both used to be in the clinic, patients only used to talk to me. And this used to lead to a lot of fights in early married life. Till one day, then finally she clinic and she took up a job. And she said, I can't work with you because every patient walking in the practice is only you. One, then you don't allow me to talk in front of patients. Two, even if I talk, then they look at you. So they hear from me, but they say, and she actually quit practice a few years ago. It's, I think, 15 years. Na? 15 saal ho gaye na, quit karke tere ko sahi time pe room mein entry maarti hai. No, she just came back from college. Her college has started. So she is taking all asepsis precautions. She just entered. She had a bath. You know, she washed her clothes. She is now, you know, so now she is now virus free. She is what telling me. Okay. And of course, in the night, she sleeps in a separate bedroom. And I am fortunate to have a special bedroom for her. Or rather, I am fortunate to have my own bedroom in my house. You know, so we will be separated for one night today for sure. It's my day. It's my boy day today. गुड सो कन्वर बिचारी अभी तक सवाल के लिए रुकी है ना इसका सॉल्यूशन ऐसा है कि आई गिव द आंसर एक्चुअली आई गिव द आंसर द फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट राइट डाउन द वंस हु आर नॉट येट मैरिड प्लीज राइट डाउन नेवर मैरी अ डेंटिस्ट सो इट्स एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल वुमेन नेवर मैरी द सेम प्रोफेशन माय यंगर डॉटर आरती इज एन आर्किटेक्ट एंड आई एम जस्ट प्रेइंग दैट शी डज नॉट मैरी एन आर्किटेक्ट I recently asked her, Aarti, she's now finished her post-graduation in US. I asked her recently, are you in love with anybody? And she said, no, Papa. I mean, I don't know whether that's a truth or a hide or whatever. But she gave me one answer. Papa, I tell you only when I stand on my own feet. I was impressed with that answer, right? Anyway, I am only worried that hope she's not in love with an architect because that could be a problem for her profession also, okay? So first and foremost, if you're not married, girls do not get married to a same professional and definitely not a dentist. Why especially not a dentist? Write this down. Nor you wanted to be ever a dentist in life, nor he wanted to be ever a dentist in life. If you fall into this 98% category, right? Ek bechara, jisko kabhi dentist banna nahi tha, एक बेचारी जिसको कभी जिंदगी में डेंटिस्ट नहीं बनना था आपको क्या लगता है कि दो ऐसे बेचारे जो जिंदगी में ये नहीं करना चाहते थे साथ में आके खुशी से कर पाएंगे आंसर मी क्या कर पाएंगे खुशी से कैन दे हैव दिस टुगेदर एंड ट्रस्ट मी द आंसर इज नो वी मेक इट हैपन इट्स अ डिफरेंट स्टोरी इफ यू मेक इट हैपन यू आर रियली ग्रेट You are really great. But let's talk about 90% dentists. Let's talk about 90% of us. And 90% of us are only driving the vehicle. Jindagi ki gaadi chala rahe. That's it. We probably are not doing it happily. And that's the reason why money becomes the central part of human life. Okay? That's one of the reasons. So, ek bechara jisko dentist banna nahi tha, ek bechari jisko dentist banna nahi tha, दो बेचारे ट्रस्ट मी कैन नेवर मेक अ हैप्पी करियर इन डेंटिस्ट You want a solution for this? And if you married to a dentist, have separate clinics. That's the biggest and the best solution. Best. But remember, separate clinics comes with one caution. In life, there is a great possibility that the female dentist, so this is for men who are listening to me. You have to decide after I say something, whether you will be really happy with this or you would have issues with this. Be frank on your comments box or later on be frank in my WhatsApp. There is a great possibility that the wife dentist earns 10 lakh rupees a month, even being a BDS, and a husband dentist who is an MDS ortho earning 6 lakh rupees a month. Yes, it's possible. There are dentists where this discrepancy is there. Okay, so be ready for this, because male ego is one huge concept in the world. It is so sad that we have it. I don't know when males will get rid of it. I just don't know. Correct? We need to work towards it. All of us need to work towards it. The males listening to me, we ourselves need to work towards it. Okay? Example, let's take Nigam and Hetal from Rajkot. Correct? If Nigam and Hetal work in the same clinic, but this is the second solution. But if you keep your account separate, if you keep your chartered accountant also separate, if you do not discuss money, how much you are earning together, how much you are earning in life, you don't share these things with your spouse at all, trust me, you will have a more happy life. Everybody, all dental couples, and this is one suggestion. If you cannot have two separate clinics because you can't afford financially and you have to work in the same clinic, or even if you have two separate clinics, have two separate accounts, have two separate chartered accountants, have filed two income tax returns separately, never discuss money at home, how much you earn, how much I earn. On the first of every month, one of you put some money on the table. On the 15th of every month, the other one puts equal money possible on the table and share the expenses of life. And yes, write down the sheet of expenses of life, but did not write the sheet of income of life and share between two. Have trust in between each other. Buy each other a gift rather than buying a gift for yourselves, because that would, you know, show that you are not spending on yourselves. Correct? So I'm just giving some tips for life probably. I may be wrong in certain things, but I think this will work beautifully. It has been working with some dentists whom I have suggested this in the past. Two separate clinics, separate accounts. In the same clinic, husband, wife, say like Hetal and Nigam in Rajkot, two separate incomes. So whatever money Hetal earns is out of the treatment what Hetal does for their clinic. Hetal becomes the consultant of Sanjeevani Dental Clinic. Okay? Dr. Nigam, her husband, becomes the consultant for his clinic. He earns his money out of it. Okay? Do not compare the incomes, because Hetal is an endo lady and Nigam is an implant guy. Correct? I'm sure implant earning is more than endo, unless Hetal reaches that level that she charges 30,000 rupee a root canal equal to Nigam, who charges say 30,000 rupee an implant. Then it's a different story, correct? But if you don't share this data with each other, I think life can be really beautiful. So this is one thing. Another small thing. Somebody sent me a message today morning, because when I asked that lady, are you married to a dentist? Are you married? She said, no, I'm not married. Then I asked her, are you in love with a dentist? And she asked the question, so what do you mean, sir? I can still take my decision. Yes, the decision is, if you are in love with a dentist and not yet married, break up. Take it from me. Because looking at women who are struggling with their life with men dentists, it would be better to happily separate at this point of time, you know, where you are really unsure about what's going to happen, rather than, so you should have not fallen in love blindly, but you should have fallen in love smart. Okay? Some women who are presently in love, or some men who are presently in love with a woman dentist, will be quit na khush with my statement. Hena? But it's a true fact of life, I personally feel. And if you still, get married, negotiate your life nicely. Learn to negotiate your life nicely. You know, there are ways to do it. There are ways to do
it. Sir, I differ on this.
Okay. You were born to differ. You know, you were born to differ. You are a lady who, because of this, are known. Correct? So continue the way you are. And we always need a person to contradict everything in life, because then only the person who says X, if there is no Y to it, X will always believe he is right. Correct? But X against Y, there has to be an answer called Z. And that Z is a solution between an X comment and a Y comment. Correct? Nobody can be dominant. But one more thing which I wanted to tell, I just forgot. It was very, very important. It was earning money ho gaya. It was falling in love ho gaya. It was taking that decision of marriage ho gaya. Anyway, welcome back to bed. Hopefully, when
there's a third point.
I got it. Suppose you are in the same clinic and you want to manage the child also, and you want to have a, you want a convert to not have the problem what you said, that patient only hear him, right? Why do you guys work in the clinic at the same times? Why can't you be in the clinic and at that time he goes for consultations, or he goes, works with another dentist, or works at a hospital, or manages the house and children? And why can't you enter the clinic? So now whenever you are alone in the clinic, you become the owner and the master of the clinic. And then the patients will respect whoever is present. A time will come when the patients who get used to Dr. Kanwar Malik will not accept Kanwar Malik's husband to treat them. Yes, because I will be comfortable with you as a dentist. I'll be comfortable. I would say, nahi, Dr. Saab, Dr. Kanwar Malik Saab ka haath hai na bahut halka hai. I will talk to the receptionist outside. Oh, Dr. Saab ka haath bahut bhari hai. Yes, that's a possibility. But for that, you need to be alone in the practice with your set of staff members. Or you, sir, you can have, that's no problem.
We are having two clinics and we are working differently. And both are going on alternate days.
So we can't tolerate each other. So what's the problem? Hai na? So I think, so the question is not yours, the question is some friend of yours. You know, ask the question. Okay, great. Two clinics, so you are lucky, man. You're so lucky.
This was the option. That's why I got married. I told him before marriage only that I'll be working on my own clinic, and he accepted.
Follow what type of personality Kanwar is.
Strong and dynamic.
Thank you.
Now, one person from crowd is asking, Nupur Verma, I'm already married to a dentist, now what to do?
Let's call not them crowd, let's call them our honorable participants.
Honorable participants, yes, sir.
Yes, the webinar. Learn to respect.
So, Nupur Verma is asking, she's already married to a dentist and she, now what to do? But you have answered that beforehand only.
Already married to a dentist and now what to do? Oh, so no regrets. No regrets, Nupur. Okay, even I got married to a dentist 32 years ago, no regrets at all. Absolutely fine. But then learn to talk to each other, learn to negotiate your lives nicely, you know. And keep love as the solid thing in between, and I think everything will fall in place absolutely beautifully, like it has fallen in place for Sayogita and Avinash. So, and if you want, they also take a course on this. Okay, so you can contact her on her private message, and Sayogita is announcing her 2-day program for dentist couples only.
No, sir. There is somebody who is, Dr. Meera has said it solved many dilemmas which were there in mind. Then Nidhi Patel is up.
I know Dr. Meera, I think it's Meera Chandra, right? I think
yes,
so.
Yes, sir. Meera
yes,
Chandra.
I know.
Yeah.
She's been attending all the webinars. I see her name every now and then in all my webinars.
Yes.
If you have any dilemma, Dr. Meera, which you think you cannot ask in the comment box, you are welcome to send a private WhatsApp message to me on my mobile number, which I'll announce at the end of the program.
Now, yes, one more person had asked, she's a alone female dentist, and now her, after COVID, her mother-in-law and father-in-law are not allowing, or the husband is also not allowing her to go back to practice. Now, what she can do now?
Perfect. First question, are you afraid yourselves?
Yes.
Are you afraid yourselves? Please answer in the comment box quickly if you're listening. All those who have asked questions, please be present to answer, because I'm going to ask you some questions. Are you yourselves afraid? If the answer is yes, then the father-in-law, mother-in-law and husband already know it, and I think they are telling you the right thing. But if you are not afraid, the best way of conversing with them is, tell them, if your daughter-in-law today was a pulmonologist, and today your daughter-in-law was the most sought-after doctor in the medical profession during COVID-19 times, and if I, the pulmonologist, your wife and your daughter-in-law, my dear mother-in-law, will not suppose go for her duty as a doctor and pulmonologist, thousands of patients will die. Would you like, my dear family, to live life with this guilt forever, that just because we are afraid that you are not allowing me to go to perform my duty as a doctor? Second example, ask them, today if your son was a major in Indian military, correct? And with the tension on the border, which is happening just now, if your son was called for duty straight in Ladakh, what would you have done? You would have told your son, or as a wife, would have told my major or my lieutenant or my cadet husband in Indian Navy, nahi, mat jana, kuch bhi ho sakta hai, hai na?
True.
Arey, what are we talking? Arey, you chose the profession of dentistry for whatever reason. Now you became a doctor. Perform your duty as a doctor first, and then call yourselves a dentist later. I don't understand only these dentists who are sitting at home. What are we doing? If you're sitting at home afraid, why can't you participate as a COVID warrior? You are applauding every COVID warrior. You are saying, great, my cousin brother is a COVID warrior doing so good at Bombay Hospital. But we are sitting at home like chickens. What are we talking? So educate your family by giving these examples. Make them feel proud. In fact, tell them, tomorrow when I go and start my clinic, and suppose you had a severe dental pain and I was not a dentist and every dentist was closed, correct? Dental pain is worse than delivery pain, is what women have told me in life. And if this is true, how would you? And if the mother-in-law had a natural delivery, and if she, by mistake, says, haan beta, delivery pain se to daant ka dard bahut hota hai, then to take that opportunity to feed into our brain. Imagine fir hum kya karte, hai na? This is how you negotiate with people. This is how you talk smartly with people. People need to be connected by true stories and life examples. Correct?
True stories and life.
Sayogita, you learned this on the DBM platform. People only connect with stories. If you are not, you need to listen to Dr. Christian Coachman,
yes,
to Florin Hofer.
Yes.
Only people connect to stories, and they should be real stories, real examples, and they will connect. In fact, I'm telling you, next day your mother-in-law and your husband will drop you to the clinic, even if he's not a dentist. Like I am dropping my wife every day morning at 7:15 so that she gets her pickup by Dr. Rahul at near his residence. Yes, I am doing it. And I am a cardiac patient, I am a diabetic patient, I am a severe comorbidity person. My age is also not right to move out. But I am proud that Meenakshi is already going to college. Right? So yes.
Yes.
Usra.
So
I also have two more.
Yeah. Ask.
Is there anybody? So now Sayogita, you can give an offer to did Anand and Abhishek give an offer to anybody of the doctors who are in coming off if they wish to come live face to face, then they need to send quickly their WhatsApp number or email ID in the comments to them and they will send a link to join in instantly.
Okay. Dr. Rashmi has asked, GK, she's a single mom and she wants tips and she wants to be a full-time dentist as well.
Single mom. And she wants to be a full-time dentist. Anna, I like. Single mom is the correct word. Yes, single mom is multiple things. Single mom means you adopted a child. Single mom could be you got married and you got divorced and you have a child out of the marriage. Forget the past now completely. I think stand on your own feet. Start your clinic for sure. You know, upgrade your skills, upgrade your knowledge. Develop yourselves in at least two subjects in dentistry. Do not try to be jack of all and master of all. You will never be able to make it. If you are not confident of starting your own clinic or if you do not have funds to start your own clinic, try and take a bank loan if you are the dynamic or the strong type personalities. If you are not even that type, then develop knowledge and skill first up to a certain level. Watch my previous three lectures. Follow the 100 teeth formula. So if you love endo, do endo courses, at least one basic and one advanced. Practice endodontics on 100 extracted teeth. Get them certified by the educators from whom you learned that. And then go to a senior dentist where you wish to work. Okay? And don't go with your CV. Go with a suitcase of this 100 root canal teeth, 300 x-rays. Carry some extracted teeth. Do few root canals in front of that dentist to prove your clinical hand. And then trust me, tell the dentist, even if it is your mother just now, or even if it is a root canal to be done in your mouth just now, I will confidently do it. Correct? Yes. So be confident and enter. Because friends, remember, if your knowledge and if your technique has perfect, knowledge is here, technique has been practiced 100 times, and you have acquired these skills, confidence will be a gift to you and you will probably only have an issue with managing the saliva, the tongue, the cheeks and the lip of the patient, for which you get appliances to put in the mouth these days, correct, isolators, and you can comfortably work. You know, look at my panelist, Dr. Kanwar. She was sweating before the program and now she is comfortable. She is smiling actually. So she has the confidence in her. It was just to begin with. So today's WDA platform was her first patient in life. And I am so confident about if I employ Dr. Kanwar in my practice, I am sure I will tell Dr. Kanwar, I think I need not go to my endodontist anymore. You are equal to them. Please do this half root canal which I have done last time and complete it. I'll be so confident. Correct? So who stops you? Anna? There is nothing like single mother. Also, I feel change that language of calling yourselves a single mother. Let's call it, I am a proud mother. Okay? Let people guess whether it is out of marriage, not out of marriage, adopted, God knows what they want to feel. But you are a proud mother. Remember, men cannot deliver. I am still waiting for mother-in-law question. I am still waiting for mother-in-law question. I will give the mic. I think Abhishek needs to ask because a mother-in-law question coming it from a son's mouth, I think would be the most perfect one. Bolo, Abhishek.
I got a message from one of your listener. She messaged me, please ask sir how to handle mother-in-law.
Yay! Sai, I was waiting for this. So women, wherever you are, and if you are listening, even if you are a non-dentist, this is for you. Male dentist, you can listen certain part. I may say something for young generation dentists who are not yet married. All male dentists, take it in a nicer way. Do not feel bad about what I say. Abhishek, I want you on the screen. I like your face. You know, because I want that son to listen to me when I talk this. So to begin with, how to tackle mother-in-law? And the first thing is you have to understand Ekta Kapoor. I hope everybody knows Ekta Kapoor. Right? She made millions of rupees, crores of rupees on this fantastic relationship called mother-in-law and daughter-in-law. Fantastic, you know. Forget those extramarital affairs and all. That is kind of extra mother-in-laws. But she really made money because she knew one thing. This is one issue which is sellable. There is no solution to it in life. Correct? Whatever you do. I received some comments, or I have received yesterday a message on my mobile. Sir, my mother-in-law is very cute. And my instant answer is, beta, kitne saal ho gaye shaadi ko? And the answer is, sir, 8 saal ho gaye. Main bola, beta, mere saal, mere shaadi ko 8 saal ke baad hi volcano jaisa eruption hua. Can you believe that? Me and Meenakshi separated from my parents after 8 years into marriage. And like an idiot man of the family, I never realized that the lava is building up between these two women for at least 7 years in my house. Got it? Because I, the boy of the house, was busy trying to stand on my own feet, busy working for 18 hours a day to earn money to look after my family, my children, and life just took over, and I neglected the part of this part of relationship. Now the fun part is whom to blame. Should I blame my mother? Should I blame my wife? Well, both are correct in their own way. The mother has a problem because she is now jealous about losing her son to a different woman. Correct? That's the big problem. She doesn't accept that, but she has to. Correct? So what happens then? The boy, no woman thinks this. Write this down. I have gone through hell in life. Trust me on this one. Okay? Do you know the man gets chakofied, kya bolte isko? Pisofied, crushed in between these two women in life? He has to have two roles. One to tell the mother and one to tell the wife. Wife, the kiss can be here. Mother, the kiss is here. Correct? And this is pushing the thing below the carpet. Just below the carpet. I have done it. I know it. Correct? There is only one way out. Correct? And that way is to separate. Well, I think that's the not the way out. Because what do you achieve by separation? I think already Dr. Kanwar has asked me, or Dr. Payal asked me, you know, how do I look after my children then? What happens? So a joint family was a much better proposition than a single family. Yes, I agreed. No doubt of it. But then trust me, the girl going to the boy's house, staying with the mother-in-law and the father-in-law is not working. The world has proved it for generations now, literally after the joint family structure started breaking. Actually, the structure started breaking probably because of this reason. Another reason could be money. But that's what Hindi movies have shown it every now and then since I was a child. And I think today also the same story. So if we break a family, what we achieved in life is a big zero. We achieved nothing in life. Correct? What is the solution then? Stay separate? No, no. Correct? The other solution, which nobody has ever tried. That's why I'm trying every time, and nowadays I'm trying to say, why not change the world? Why not, Abhishek, you go and stay with your wife's family? See, there is already a smile. If Akash Akinwar is listening to me just now, I'm thinking Akash will 100% agree to me. Because Akash Vakinwar and Priya Karkanis, if they book a OYO room today, Akash, if you're and Priya, if you're listening, first of all, love you. Great job with mobile photography. I am enjoying it on Facebook. Correct?
Yeah.
Raj is a very forward man. Correct? He's not even asked Priya ever to change her name to Priya Karkani's Akinwar. He, I think, never did it. I think I'm really, really proud of it. Correct? And maintain that identity. I don't know how he solves the problem when he books Oyo rooms, because in Oyo rooms, the surname has to be same, or you need to prove that you are husband and wife. I'm sure Akash carries a marriage certificate with you. But I think Akash will agree with me. Why we meant can't, you know, we need to explore this option now. It's high time. I think thousands of years have passed, and the boy girl going to the boy's house option is not working. Families are separating, breakups are happening in family, or relationships are horrible. Why can't we explore the third possibility now, correct? Of the boy going to the girl's house. According to me, this should work. Reason is, then we will, boys, we'll have a father-in-law and we will have a mother-in-law. Correct? Mother-in-law needs a company for his beer or a wine or a whiskey, and we will be perfect company for him. Absolutely perfect. So, hum dono ka to jamne wala hai. Brother, hai na? Aur dusra ek hai ki we men probably are configured differently, you know. So we will be completely having a different relationship with our mother-in-law, which I can, I think, take from our present relationship with our mother-in-law. You know, some of us like our mother-in-law even better than our own mother because of several reasons, you know. So I think, Abhishek, let's make the beginning with you and Anand telling your families that you are now onwards moving yourselves to your wife's house. Correct?
I have no objection to it. I accept it publicly.
And if you have wife and mother, he needs to have that change in his mindset, and he needs to explore the possibility, and somebody has to start his journey. I don't know who will start. My wife is here, and if I, should I say, with your permission, that if life gives me an opportunity to remarry ever again, I don't mind exploring this possibility even at this age. Okay? She is saying, when are you getting married? She just proposed me again. So what she is actually telling me, smiling, is, chal divorce paper sign karte hai. Correct? Aur jaise 6 mahine mein divorce hota hai, dubara karte hai. Sahi hai na? I really don't mind trying this option. I think women outside dentistry, or women who are listening to me today, need to talk to dentistry about this proposal of mine and start a forum and keep me on the forum. And I would love to, you know, do something in this field for some time now. So this is one definite option to explore. Hai na? Baki dusra kya kar se ho mother-in-law ko? Ek tisra option bhi hai. All daughter-in-laws, why don't you all think that someday you too will be a mother-in-law, especially if you have a son, and especially if this tradition of a girl coming to a womb, you know, a boy's side continues when your sons get married, correct? Why don't you look at life, how you will behave in future, and convey this to your present mother-in-law, correct? Also, I think fourth thing, what does your mother-in-law actually need? You know, she needs love and affection. Because as my study with my parents go, and probably go with us in some more time, as age advances, that touch, that affection becomes less and lesser. I've seen it with my parents, correct? Physical touch is not there anymore. They love each other is a different story. So I think the woman is lacking that security in life, and men have this typical habit of, you know, talking something good about Sayogita in front of my own wife. He is now video recording me, I think so. You know, they, men have this typical habit, you know, they don't do it intentionally. It's a genetic problem with men, or we are wired that way, but women take it instantly, you know. So I think what's our mother-in-law need? She needs that little hug every day. She needs that, you know, she needs to know that you are not her daughter, of course, but you are much more than her daughter. She needs an occasional movie with you. She needs probably what her husband cannot give her. Her son is neglecting her because he wants to stand on his own feet. Correct? She needs all that, I think so. If we can, you know, manage all those things, keep our own egos aside, I think things can work much, much better. Correct? If it doesn't work, for sustain separate is an option. But then my suggestion, which is what I did in life after a few years of separation, was I saw that my parents stayed in front of us, literally. Okay. So we had two separate houses, but we were together. Correct? But of course, the two separate kitchens, again, concept doesn't work in India. It is again a problem. And once a relationship soars, it is very difficult to get back in life. So now suggestion to very young dentists who are not married or the ones who are single moms. And if you wish to get married again to a dentist or a non-dentist, men dentist, please don't get angry on what I am going to say. Take it in a nicer way. Young dentist, find a boy who does not have a mother. Sorry to say this. Jindagi ke aadhe problem khatam. आधे प्रॉब्लम खत्म. संयोगिता तो आइडिया पसंद आ गया है ना, बट एक ख्याल रहे इसका फ्लिप साइड क्या है. संयोगिता को कुछ कभी पूछने का नहीं. मेरे को अविनाश के साथ में आई वांट टू सिट वन डे टू एक्चुअली अंडरस्टैंड दिस लेडी बिकॉज आई एम श्योर व्हाट आई नो एंड व्हाट शी इज डूइंग नाउ. इफ अविनाश सेज ए शी सेज बी शी इज अ एंड देयर इज अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट व्हिच इज कॉल्ड सी एंड देन देयर इज अ कॉम्प्रोमाइज कॉल्ड अगेन सी. Correct? And then there is a kiss called K, and then there is a kiss called on the path again. We are also the same. Most are. Anyway, Dusra, the flip side of not having a mother-in-law is you will not get a boy till you are 40 years of age, because that would be.
That is true.
Normally 40 or even 50, 55. When the mother-in-law comes off. Okay? So you'll have to wait little too long to get married. In fact, that would be the time for you to become a mother-in-law. So I think the wait is not worth all this. You know?
Okay.
So these are my tricks in life. They are little different. Some of them little out of the box. Because I am out of box thinker. I know it. I don't look at anything in life sitting inside the box. The moment I realize that I'm sitting in the box and looking at life, there is a problem. I get out of that, look at my life from outside the box or somebody's life from outside their life. And then there are always solutions which come in the brain. Good. Anything else? So Avinash, when I'm so you moving.
Sir, we have another question which is very important, I feel. One of the participants, she is saying she is having pressure of in-laws to start family planning, but she is career oriented.
Yeah.
Is
what should be first, what should she be doing? Open clinic or should start family planning?
Sahi hai. Chalo, likho wapas same. Are you a dynamic, a strong or a calm or this thing? Correct? Pehla wo likho tu kaun hai. है ना, अगर तू डायनेमिक है तो यू विल गेट प्रेग्नेंट टुनाइट. ओके, यू प्रॉमिस ऑन कमेंट. यस, इफ योर हस्बैंड इज अ डेंटिस्ट यू कैन टाइप हिम. यस, आई विल मेक हर प्रेग्नेंट टुनाइट. डन. यू विल, कोविड टाइम इज परफेक्ट टाइम नाउ. यू नो, बाय नाउ कोविड गेट ओवर, यू कैन डिलीवर अ बेबी. डोंट वरी अबाउट सेफ बेबी एंड ऑल, इट विल बी ऑल सेफ. है ना, start working on your clinic also now, because now another 2 months and prices of properties will drop down, and the right time to buy a place and right time to, you know, plan for your clinic. The day you deliver the baby, keep your inauguration of the clinic within, the rule is say 40 days woman in does not go out of the house. Because you are dynamic, you change the rule. You on 15th day or the 10th day or the 5th day say, I am opening the grand opening of the clinic. The baby is going to bless the clinic. In fact, the baby is going to cut the ribbon of the clinic. Anna? Karna, why not? Who is stopping you to do all these things together? Why one should come first and one should come later? Why? In fact, tell your mother-in-law, I mean, I would love my baby to be raised like your son. I would like you to pass on all what you have done for your son. And that's why I love your son. All women, don't waste time loving your husbands. Trust me. Don't waste time. Love your mother-in-laws. You know, love them so much that one day they tell your husband or their son, ki dekh, ye parai aurat bhi mere ko tere se jyada pyar karti hai. Ye parai aurat bhi tere se mere ko jyada time deti hai. Tu to kuch nahi karta kamina, nikamma, nikamma. Hai na? I think we need to reach that level in life. Correct? सही है ना. सो क्या सोचना है उसमें, बच्चा पहले के वो पहले, है ना. सो नो फैमिली प्लानिंग टुनाइट. योर क्वेश्चन वाज वेरी कंफ्यूजिंग वेदर टू हैव और नॉट टू हैव. आई थिंक अभिषेक आल्सो हैड दैट सेम एक्सप्रेशन ऑन हिज फेस. ये पूछना क्या चाहते हैं, इसको चाहिए कि नहीं चाहिए, है ना. चाहिए हमको, है ना. चलो
सर, रसिका इज आस्किंग मदर इन लॉ को पटाने का नुस्खा दीजिए. सर बता चुके सर आप कैसे.
मदर इन लॉ को पटाने का नहीं, बिकॉज इफ यू ट्राई टू पटाओ इट्स लाइक ट्राइंग टू कन्विंस अ पेशेंट फॉर अ ट्रीटमेंट प्लान. बट इफ यू ट्राई टू कन्विंस पेशेंट्स फॉर अ ट्रीटमेंट प्लान द आंसर विल बी आई विल लेट यू नो डॉक्टर एंड द पेशेंट नेवर कम्स बैक. ओके, नेवर ट्राई टू कन्विंस पीपल, इट विल नेवर हैपन. ओके, माय वाइफ डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी योगा गुरु has been trying to convince me to do yoga for several years and I don't do anything out of it. Okay, for her meditation is the peak of life. For me, talking like this on a WDA platform is meditation for me. She just refuses to understand that this could also be a level of meditation. So she agrees nowadays, but this could also be a level of meditation for me. Okay. Anyway, so don't try to convince people. The more we try to convince, the more we go away from it. Correct? You give life stories, create life examples, take your mom, mother-in-law, like how you would have taken your mother for anything in life. You know, buy those things for your mother-in-law and father-in-law, what you would have bought for your own mother and your own father. Trust me, don't gift your husband anything on his birthday. Trust me, as a husband, I'm telling you, we don't expect anything on our birthday. Anything. Okay? What we would probably expect on our birthday is a great nine. Great nine. Okay? Yes. I hope you understood what I mean. Nine. Correct?
That Dr. Patil has some question, I suppose. Yes, Dr. Samida.
बहुत सारे ये हो सकते हैं. सो व्हाई डोंट यू, यू नो व्हाई यू वेस्टिंग टाइम ऑन योर हस्बैंड. आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड. हस्बैंड का ना कॉन्फिगरेशन अलग ही है. उनको ना खाना चाहिए, उनका ना पेट भरना चाहिए. बराबर. एंड देन आई डोंट हैव टू से बियॉन्ड दैट.
लॉकडाउन हैज मेड अस बेटर कुक.
लॉकडाउन हैज दे शुड बी हैप्पी बियॉन्ड द स्टमक. If they are happy beyond the stomach, they don't want anything else in life. Ask any husband of yours or any man. Correct? So why are you wasting your time making a... Why you are leaving your mother-in-law's and father-in-law's house for your stupid husband? Why? Instead, tell your husband, tere ko tere mummy daddy ko chhodke jana hai, tu ja sakta hai, main to idhar hi rahungi. Yes, sahi. Sahi hai, na? Then... Hello, ask next.
So I'll just take the focus on the dentist again, the female dentist again. So how to, like, in, this question comes from your recent lecture, the 9-to-5 culture, working culture for people in Western people. So after that, after 5 o'clock is the time for our kids. And as you mentioned in the earlier lecture, we have to be. We have to give time to social responsibilities, join some yoga, golf.
Perfect. Self-care. Whether your husband is a dentist or a non-dentist, it doesn't matter here at all. Correct. Dentistry is one beautiful branch. that's for sure for females, so it is absolutely perfect. Okay, you can set your own timings the way you want, you can manage your clinic, you can manage your life as per your children. If your husband is not contributing to PTAs, if your husband is not like me, your husband is not ready to drop the school children to school and pick up, and he's just not made for all these things, or he refuses to take this responsibility, and your father-in-law cannot go and drop your children or anything like this, don't worry at all. You make your own timetable of life. Okay? Think first of all that you're having your own private clinic. Even if it's with your husband, it's your own private clinic. You set your own rules of your life, own timings of your life, everything on. Correct? My suggestion for all women dentists. Start your clinic at around 10 in the morning and close your clinic by around 5 in the evening. 7 hours of work every day, more than enough. In fact, all rich patients, you will get between 10 and 5. You will get faster name, faster fame between 10 and 5. Okay, I've already spoken about this in my What After MDS, What After BDS lecture. 10 to 5, 9:30 to 5:30 is the best thing to do, right? The dentist woman is career oriented, has her own practice. You need to work on getting patients. Getting. So if Dr. Priyanka, if you're listening to me from Rajasthan, yesterday we had a conversation. You want to start, suppose your own practice. You have a practice and you want to make it run. And it's already 3 and 5 years of life. Okay. And it's not picking up. The reason it's not picking up because you are doing the wrong type of marketing. Okay, spending money on Facebook, spending money on websites does not get patients. It'll get you just 2% of patients. Trust me. What you need to do is you need to socialize in life. Human beings love to meet. Once we meet, example, today I saw Samida for the first time. I saw Kanwar and Payal for the first time, right? Tomorrow when we meet again in person, I will be more comfortable with you. You will be more comfortable with me. Someday you will invite me and my wife for dinner at your place, and we will accept the dinner and we will come over dinner and we will be more closer. Correct? Then we will probably meet because I will be dropping my grandchildren to my school, and I happen to meet you dropping your children. We will come even better know each other. And one day then, if I was a patient, a normal person, I will ask, Dr. Kanwar, can I get your visiting card? I have a small issue with my tooth, or my wife has a small issue with her tooth. And people like to first...
I would be blessed, sir.
Yes, people like to be first in a relationship with a human being. And once that trust is developed, they become our patients. So what is the secret what you need to follow in today's world is the best time of practice, which the whole world practices this time. Okay. Only India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. And Indians practicing abroad practice morning, evening, and ruin their family life and ruin their life work balance. 9 to 5. I've done this mistake and I've corrected this mistake in life. Okay. In the morning, get up at say 7. Go and play a game or a yoga session or something for 45 minutes. Take out time for this, even if you have children. Today, you can do these programs even online. Even online, you can know 50 people on Zoom. And if you are doing yoga with these 50 people for 30 days in a month, they start knowing you for everything. Correct? They are on your WhatsApp group. You communicate with them. Slowly they come to know, hey, you are a dentist, correct? And maybe 15 days later, they one day say, hey, Dr. Samida, yaar, my father-in-law has a toothache. You know, I need your services. Are you open? Can I come? See how this happens. So this can happen, Sayogita, even in the online world today. Because online is also a personal connection between you and me, guys, just now. Correct? Okay. And I was not seeing anybody's face. I was hating that connection because I was not connected to anybody. The moment I saw Abhishek, I saw you, I am feeling connected in life. So imagine when everything opens up and at 7:30 in the morning, if you join a yoga class, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, you meet a group of say 20 people. Correct? On the same day after coming home, you quickly finish your cooking, shooking, everything. Because your husband is not like Rajiv Verma and does not cook at all. Right? Wife is correcting now, but I'm proud to say it. In front of all of you, I promise you today that till we are together, she will never, ever, ever enter the kitchen. Never, ever.
Amazing.
Such was the easiest, such a pappu thing in life. Easiest. And I don't know why women crib about cooking. I meet so many women, some humko hi karna padta hai, humko hi cook karna padta hai. अरे क्या इसमें ऐसा पप्पू थिंग कुछ नहीं है उसका एक कारण है शायद आपको तुमको पसंद नहीं आता है कुकिंग बिकॉज यू डोंट लव इट राइट आई लव इट सो आस्क योर हस्बैंड्स टू एक्सप्लोर द पॉसिबिलिटी आई हैव गिवन दिस चैलेंज टू डॉक्टर सतीश बलगट सतीश इफ यू आर लिसनिंग पुट इट इन कमेंट्स एंड सतीश एक्सेप्टेड माई चैलेंज एंड हैज कुक्ड पोहा दैट डे राइट एंड ही इज ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट वेदर ही हैज दैट पैशन सो एनीवे सुबह 7:30 से 8:00, 7:30 से 8:30 8:30 व्हाटएवर 45 मिनट योगा करो 20 लोगों को मिलो करेक्ट फिर सब कुछ काम करके बच्चे को स्कूल ड्रॉप करके क्लिनिक चले जाओ या मदर इन लॉ को बोलो तू चल सकती है घूम सकती है एक ड्राइवर है गाड़ी लेके जा ड्रॉप करके आ जा ठीक है अगर परवड़ता है तो गाड़ी ड्राइवर है सब कुछ है मेड है कुछ भी हो सकता है यार हाँ. फिर क्लिनिक होने के बाद भी घर आओ क्लिनिक पे ऑफकोर्स यू कैन बी ऑन वीडियो कॉल विथ योर किड्स यू कैन बी ऑन वीडियो कॉल योर मदर इन लॉ वीडियो कॉल टूडे यूज टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर एवरीथिंग वाई नॉट है ना हाँ दे नो नीड टू पुट अ सिक्योरिटी कैमरा एवरीवेयर अभी बच्चे ने क्या किया अभी बच्चा गिरा अभी बच्चा का इदात गिरा अभी बच्चा को पॉटी हुआ दे नो नीड टू लीव दैट लीव इट ऑन टू द मदर इन लॉ टू मैनेज यार लेट देम मैनेज दे विल एंजॉय डूइंग इट देयर वे है ना चल तू भूल जाने का घर घर भी सब कुछ 5 बजे क्लिनिक कम करते थे घर आ घर आने के बाद में यू कुड प्ले अ बैडमिंटन गेम फॉर हाफ एन आवर 45 मिनट्स और समथिंग और डू समथिंग एल्स इन लाइफ है ना व्हाट इज द इंटेंशन मीट अनदर 20 पीपल एट बैडमिंटन है ना डू समथिंग ऑन ट्यूसडे थर्सडे सैटरडे अगेन मॉर्निंग में ज्वाइन अ जिम नाउ डिफरेंट एक्टिविटी इन द इवनिंग ज्वाइन सम अदर पॉसिबिलिटी अ कुकिंग क्लास व्हाई डोंट ऑल मेन ज्वाइन अ कुकिंग क्लास of a woman. I don't know. I think I'm going to join. Anand, you need to join a woman's cooking class. First of all, the woman teacher, cooking class wali, she's going to go, eh? Dr. Saab, aap kya cooking class mein? Bas udhar hi tera USP ban gaya. Barabar, tu 5 din ka cooking class karega na, wo jitni 10 ladies hai na, wo tera card to 5th din pakka mangegi. Aur apne husbands ko jaake bolegi, ek Dr. Anand hai, ek dentist hai, cooking class mein aaya tha. Sahi? Dekh, tera pura naam ho gaya. ये 5 लेडीज तेरे को पेशेंट्स पक्का भेजेगी मैं लिख के देता हूँ समझा ना आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ कुकिंग क्लास शॉर्टली ऑनलाइन कुकिंग क्लास एक्सक्लूसिवली फॉर विमेन डेंटिस्ट एंड डेंटिस्ट टू से दैट दे डोंट लाइक कुकिंग कुकिंग इज नॉट माय यू नो आई हेट ओनली फॉर देम दे कैन एनरोल माय कुकिंग क्लास एंड आई विल मेक यू फॉल इन लव विद कुकिंग ऑल ओवर अगेन आई प्रॉमिस यू एनीवे तो 4 अगर एक्टिविटी करो ना लाइफ में चलो 4 नहीं तो 2 एक्टिविटी तो करो एडवांटेज देखो एक्टिविटी का यू विल बी फिजिकली फिट बाय डूइंग योगा और जिम और अ गेम यू राइट यू विल बी मेंटली हैप्पी साइड इफेक्ट यू विल मीट पीपल यू विल सोशलाइज दैट ऑल्सो विल बी एन हैविंग एन इफेक्ट ऑन योर मेंटल हेल्थ करेक्ट दैट विल बिल्ड रिलेशनशिप The biggest side effect of it, 6 months down the line, these people are going to ask for your visiting card, your business card, and they are going to become your patients. Take it from writing from me. And 80% of your patients are going to be from this bank. And then this bank will get you another 80% of patients. Yesterday, like Dr. Coachman said, make them your fan. And the moment they become your fan, they will get you 80% patients by word of mouth. You don't need any marketing, trust me, in today's world also. What we are losing is this human touch. And you're wasting your time sitting in your practice, patients will come. Correct? Marketing on YouTube does not work. Marketing on YouTube you want to do, Anand? Start your some extra thing what you have, that one extra thing. Suppose you are a great, great, great basketball player. Start a YouTube channel, teach people how to play basketball. That community of people will slowly become your patients when they come to know that you are a dentist. Understood? There is no need to, put your dental clinic name on the video and teach people about implants and brushing and all. There's no need. That's called advertising. Advertising does not get patients. Relationship building gets patients. So women dentists, you to have that one additional power, which I feel men don't have. Correct? You have that emotional connect with people. Exploit that to the fullest. But always remember, when you do these kind of activities, don't go with the intention that I want a patient out of this yoga group. Because human beings can smell this dirty mentality of another human being. And you will never get patients. They will all talk behind your back. So go for health reasons. Go for being busy reasons. Go for managing your life and your work balance reasons. And the outcome of this will be definitely positive, definitely patience, definitely happiness, definitely success, definitely money, definitely name, definitely fame, definitely happy mother-in-law, father-in-law, definitely happy husband, definitely happy your neighbor's husband. Bolo, anything? It's almost exact.
Yes. Dr. Madhura. Yeah, Dr. Madhura Upar has asked, if we have our own dental clinic, then now or then we have to go to general practice too, even if we are specialist.
Why? Why? That means, is she an MDS?
Yes, she's an MDS.
Correct. Which subject are you an MDS? Forget it. Forget it. If you are in a community dentist MDS, why are you doing general practice? You should be working for caries prevention in India. You should be working at a global platform like UNESCO, United Nations, WHO. That means you are disrespecting your community dentistry degree and you are in the field of the in dentistry only to earn money, which I will personally fail. Shame on you. And like this for every MDS. Please don't go by my language. I am speaking from my heart just now. My heart cries for all MDS when they do general dentistry. Why can't you believe in your degree? Why can't you believe in your teachers? Why can't you believe in your... Why cannot you keep money aside for the first few years of life? Why can't you use your MDS knowledge and skill to your advantage? Why can't you follow 5-year Guru's Guru mantra after becoming MDS? Why can't you become famous first, acquire name first? Array, let money be the outcome.
Sir, you have muted yourself.
I have not muted.
All fine. Okay, by mistake. Okay.
The only person who can mute me in life is my wife. She's sitting right next to me. PTC, have a look. Okay, nobody else can mute me in life. Yogita, this is, I can't remember, I can't see, sorry. This is Anand, ek ladka dikh raha hai. This is Priyal, and this is that Zunzar Rao.
Hi,
Zunzar Rao. Hey, tell your father and mother amazing name, surname. If in second life, if I have an option of selecting my surname, this could be one of them.
So they're watching
all night. Zunzar Rao. Yes. Good. Oh, MDS, oh yeah, BDS, oh yeah. All consultants to your practice. I'll tell you what is the problem of calling consultants. Your brain says, Aila, oh, bulate, sir, wo 60% to wo leke jata hai. हमको तो 40% मिलता है उसमें 30% खर्चा होता है तो हमको कुछ मिलता ही नहीं है. That's because you are following a wrong concept in dentistry. Don't give anybody a percentage. In fact, it is unethical to give a 60-40, 70-30, 50-50 concept in medical profession. That's called cut business. Don't do that. The right thing is ask the consultant who comes to you, how much will you charge? Tell your worth. If this is a molar patient or anterior, what is your charge to do the root canal? Correct? And if suppose that consultant tends, I will charge 2,000 rupees. Correct. You negotiate whatever you want, and if you agree at say 1800 rupees for him to come and do the root canal of your patient, correct? Pay him 1800 and tell him, don't be concerned what I charge to my patient, because my charge to my patient depends upon my clinic, my expenses, my lifestyle, you know? So it cannot be percentage basis, plus percentage basis is unethical. One day when I want to write an article on this for patients, that if your doctor is paying like this to another consultant doctor coming to the practice, please do a consumer case against this dear doctor that he is charging cut practice. So whoever is listening to me today, please understand what I am trying to tell. Understood? Always ask the consultant what is your worth, and then charge your patient as per your calculation of your clinical expenses, your material expenses, whether he is getting material, you are getting material, correct? Your electricity, your telephone, your petrol, your car, your family, your what branded clothes you wear, everything will differ like that. So nothing like 60-40, 70-30 business, even in orthodontics. Stop all that, correct? So now you are the king of your money, what you get, because you decide your profits. I hope the Manish Chitnis in DBM and Sujit Pardesi both teach you all these things like this, right? And also one more thing, if you have sufficient patients and if you are happy with what you are earning and you want to practice your specialty or your prosthodentistry because you are not an MDS, start referring patients. Why do you want to even call a consultant and occupy your chair? Why can't you use your two chairs or three chairs of your practice for only your work? Why can't you appoint another MDS under your degree of MDS? Why can't a BDS appoint a MDS on salary basis under yourself? Why can't? What is the ego? Where is? I don't understand all these things here. You know? Chalo, aage.
Dr. Deepali is asking, sir, what about children's studies? Do we have to take it personally, or it gives me guilt for not giving more time for their studies? But eventually, they only have to learn how to study.
हर माँ बाप को लगता है कि अपना बेटा आइंस्टाइन बनना चाहिए, है ना? हर माँ बाप को लगता है. आजकल के माँ बाप तो वन स्टेप अहेड है, इंक्लूडिंग माय वाइफ वाज ड्यूरिंग, सो आई कैन से दी ये माँ बाप भी. वी हैड पुट अवर डॉटर इन स्केटिंग, वी हैड पुट अवर डॉटर फॉर भरतनाट्यम, वी हैड पुट अवर डॉटर फॉर होमी बाबा, करेक्ट? That was not Rajiv Verma, that was Meenakshi Verma, the mother did it, and I was against all this in life. Though of course, this all must have helped my daughters, yes. But I always told one thing to my wife, don't try to make Einsteins and Edisons out of Rajiv Verma's daughters and Meenakshi Verma's children. Our genetic composition is such that nobody in our family is a genius. Mere pure khandan mein nahi hai, tere pure khandan mein nahi hai. तो बच्चों को ये सब सिखा के मेरे को क्या लगता है वो जीनियस बनेंगे, है ना? के बाद में none of our daughters have ever done skating, none of them have ever, you know, taught any other child about mummy baba, not done anything. My elder one loves Bharatnatyam, has done a Sarangyatram, but does not get even time to do it in the United States anymore. Correct? Completely out of practice. Not them, but it was really not required. Same way, why are you really wasting your time in, you know, educating, teaching your child? Send them in a decent school. Don't have to send them in Eco Mondial, because again, by going into Eco Mondial and these type schools, your children are not going to become Einsteins. Why can't you send your children to your normal Saraswati Vidyalaya, where you were a student? If Rajiv Verma of Raja Shivaji Vidyalaya can become a doctor, why can't Rajiv Verma's daughter go to simple Vasant Vihar school? Why they need to have to go to a big school? What has changed? Nothing has changed. Correct? Same way, I don't understand why do your children need tuition? Why children need to go classes? Correct? A little supervision by you, a little supervision by your husband in a subject what he likes to sit with the child, subject what you like to sit with the child, a little contribution by one or two family or three or four family members, and I think that's enough. And if you genetically are a dumb guy, don't bother to teach the child anything. It will be waste of time. If you genetically are, you yourselves are an average person in life, वॉट आर यू ट्राइंग टू डू? ट्रस्ट यूर चाइल्ड यार, वो जितना स्कूल में पढ़ के आता है ना उतने में वो 100% पास होता. एंड कंसिडरिंग दैट वी ऑल आर डॉक्टर्स, करेक्ट, दैट मीन्स वी हैव सम एवरेज एकेडमिक क्वालिटीज इन अस, राइट? एंड इफ जेनेटिकली एंड इफ यू टू हैव प्रोड्यूस्ड इट, चेक दैट. इफ दैट्स, यू नो, दैट्स नॉट द राइट वे टू से इट, ऑल वुमेन विल गेट एंग्री. But if it's the, you know, the child is also of a father who is average brain, trust me, your child will have a decent brain. उसको पेस्टर मत करो यार, है ना, बस उसको ना साथ में बैठो यार, है ना, ज्यादा से ज्यादा उसको बैजूस लगा दो आजकल, बैजूस, बराबर कि नहीं? थोड़ा टाइम लगता है यार बच्चों को, थोड़ा बिलीव करो. वो yesterday I've got a message, sir, I cannot attend your program because my son is in 12th standard. And CBSE has organized the course exam in June. So she can't attend my program. So I told her, Sala, tu baith rahi hai program ko, tera 12th ka bachcha baith raha hai. I don't understand what is wrong with you women. Are your husbands doing it? No, they are not doing it because they know it's pointless doing it. You ladies, I don't know what you feel. You feel, Sala, dunia ka sab kuch tumhare sar pe. Tumne agar bachche ko nahi dekha, to bachcha bigad jayega. अरे हिंदी पिक्चर्स हैव टॉट अस इनफ एज अ चाइल्ड दैट अगर बच्चा बिगड़ा ना तो 80% बच्चा माँ के प्यार से ही बिगड़ता है. लेडीज बुरा नहीं मानना. धर्मेंद्र भी बोल के गया, जितेंद्र बोला था, यू नो, ये सब हीरोज मूवीज में यही बोल के गए. एंड दैट्स प्रोबेबली टू रियली व्हाट डू यू फील बिकॉज यू प्रोड्यूस अ बेबी फ्रॉम योर अम्बेलिकल कॉर्ड इज अटैच टू द बेबी दैट यू आर मोर इमोशनली कनेक्टेड विथ योर चाइल्ड. What nonsense! Before your umbilical cord got connected with the baby, man's cord got connected to you. I hope you got what I am saying. Because of that cord connection, that you have a cord connection with your baby. Trust me, men also equally love the child. But women, nahi, main maa, mera sab kuch. Aye kya? Aisa thodi hai. Hai na, don't hijack children from us, yaar. And the more you hijack them, the more the husbands go away from it and say, ye mera kaam nahi hai. Think about it what I said just now. The more the husband feels, ye mera kaam nahi hai. Wo dekh rahi hai. Waise bhi dekhta ho, toh ye bolte hai, hey, aise diaper nahi change karte. Tu kyun bhi jo, usne ulta diaper pehna hai, toh pehna de dena, kya farak padta hai? Same problem with mother-in-law. Same with mother-in-law. Mother-in-law, ye aisa nahi karte. Hamare mein aisa nahi hota. प्रॉब्लम है. अरे तो कर ना तेरे जैसा, नो प्रॉब्लम. आगे आनंद, शुड बी अनाउंस पार्ट टू, पार्ट थ्री एंड पार्ट फोर,
लाइक लास्ट टाइम सर.
बिना, हाँ बोलो.
सेकंड है.
Hey, on.
Mida. Yes.
Sir, after all the discussion what we have heard from you today, I would like to ask you then how to describe or how to, you know, consider success criteria of female dentist. Is it hard work? Is it being wealthy or being lead a happier, balanced life or is it being a famous dentist? How would you describe the success criteria?
First one, first wala. Go one by one. First wala.
Hard work.
लिख लो और अपने बच्चों को भी सिखाओ. Never have smart to work hard in life. You have to only work smart in life.
Work smart.
Remember na, ye sentence to tumne suna rahega. Ab dusra sentence mera suno.
Yes sir.
Iska karan ye hai ki hard work is mandatory in life. Because some of you will say, are hard ka zarurat hi nahi hai, smartly karte hai. Hard work is mandatory in life. Wo to karna hi padta hai. Without it to nothing in life. Chalo, next one kya tha? क्या वेल्दी होके क्या करेगी? एक बात बताओ मेरे प्यारे डेंटिस्ट भाइयों और बहनों, हम में से आज तक कौन वेल्दी बन सका? वेल्दी का डेफिनेशन बताओ. अगर मिस्टर मुकेश अंबानी बन सकते हो ना, तो मैं वेल्दी बोल सकता हूँ. बराबर ना? आप लोगों को मालूम है दैट ऑल डेंटिस्ट इन इंडिया टुगेदर, इफ वी if we file one income tax return or if we collectively show our income, that could be Mr. Ambani's one day income. Do you know that? I think one day bhi jyada hi bola. It could be 1 hour income of Mr. Ambani. So what is this wealthy? In fact, wealth is the reason for separation in family. Wealth is the reason for all the big problems of life. Why can't we live life in sufficient? That does not mean don't earn money. Earn money. Have a dream of creating wealth. But there is a difference between creating wealth and becoming wealthy. There is a huge difference. If you can understand this. Chalo. So Sujit can explain this.
Yeah.
Pardon,
being a famous dentist. Being a famous dentist.
Aray, ye toh known cheez hai. जिस डेंटिस्ट का काम एकदम घटिया रहता है वो सबसे फेमस रहता है. डेंटिस्ट को भी मालूम होता है कि मेरा क्राउन प्रेप थर्ड क्लास, मेरा रूट कनाल थर्ड क्लास, बट ही हैज द मैक्सिमम सक्सेस इन लाइफ. सो व्हाट आर वी, है ना? सो है ना, बीइंग फेमस क्या है? हु मेक्स यू फेमस यार? पीपल मेक यू फेमस. सो प्रेजेंटली सपोज इफ यू कॉल्ड मी फेमस, that's because all the audience attending on WDA has made me famous. That's it. Correct? So don't go by that famous. Famous will give you a kick and an ego.
Next. The last one was lead happy and balanced life.
Don't you think the fourth one is much better?
Yeah. Yes.
Huh? Much better?
Yes, yes. Definitely.
Ek side pe, toh we should be very clear that Mukesh Ambani toh ban nahi sakte. Barabar? Hai na? तो पैसे की रेस में भागना किसके लिए? पॉइंटलेस रनिंग बिहाइंड मनी. द ओनली थिंग व्हाट वी हैव टू प्रोबेबली रन इन लाइफ इज व्हाट? हैप्पीनेस फॉर आवरसेल्व्स, फॉर हैप्पीनेस ऑफ पीपल अराउंड अस, अवर फ्रेंड्स, अवर फैमिली. यू नो, थिंक इन लाइफ व्हाट वी कैन गिव टू आवरसेल्व्स एंड गिव टू अदर्स. आवरसेल्व्स डज नॉट मीन आवरसेल्व्स समथिंग, अ गिफ्ट, सम एडिशनल थिंग हियर. What we can give to others rather than what we can take from others. Whole life everybody is wasting in taking from others. Good, one cardiac issue with me in 2007 and life taught me a lesson that life is not about taking. Life is only about giving to others. Only giving. You know, giving mein jo aaj mere ko happiness mil raha hai na, uska koi limit hi nahi hai. No beer in this world can give me this happiness. But I am getting today from these doctors who are listening to me and my panel, you know, and from WDA. You cannot even compare. I am the wealthiest man. I have accumulated so much wealth in this lockdown. Can you believe that? It's unbelievable amount of wealth. I told that day, agar kal ko mera main bhikari bhi ban jao na, yani mera sab stock market investment khalas ho jave, और मेरा सब वाट लग जावे फाइनेंशियली, करेक्ट? आई कैन गो टू अभिषेक हाउस, आई कैन गो टू संयोगिता हाउस, आई कैन गो टू समिदास हाउस, एंड आई कैन गो टू आनंद हाउस एंड कन्वर्स हाउस एंड पायल हाउस एंड ऑल द डेंटिस्ट लिसनिंग टू मी टुडे एंड टू माय 4000 कोर्स पार्टिसिपेंट्स, एंड आई टेल देम इन रिटर्न ऑफ ब्रेकफास्ट एंड अ ब्रंच एंड अ डिनर, करेक्ट? एंड आई विल टीच यू सम रिटर्न. Can you give me this two and one night stay at your place? And I'm sure everybody will entertain me for one day. Yes or no? Isse acha wealth jindagi mein kya hai?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
List of people would be ready, sir.
Is wealth ke piche, aaj ke baad, mere ko sunne ke baad na, I want hundreds of young dentists and middle-aged dentists to follow behind this wealth of life. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, aage. Anybody has any question? All those questions which we may have missed,
Dr. Kanwar has.
You can send me this question on my WhatsApp number. Is the number going down? Yes, 98201405 26. It's on the scroll below. You can send it on that, and I will keep answering to that. Any more question, Abhishek? Puch lo, fatafat.
Yes, sir. Almost all the questions have been answered by you. Many would have not been asked publicly to any other people. There is one question many people are asking now. Those who have stopped practicing dentistry due to some or the other reason in their personal life, how can they resume their practice right now?
शुरू हो जाओ पेन पेंसिल
टेन इयर्स
शुरू हो जाओ पेन पेंसिल है ना, लिखो लाइफ का विजन क्या है, क्या करना है लाइफ में, अभी हो गया ना, अभी कम बैक. सो व्हाट यू मीन इज यू वांट टू मेक अ कम बैक. ओके, यू कैन जस्ट मेक अ कम बैक बाय ओपनिंग अ शटर टुमारो मॉर्निंग एंड स्टार्ट सिटिंग. इट विल टेक ब्लडी 5 years टू रन योर प्रैक्टिस एंड इन द मीन टाइम योर फैमिली विल टेल यू अरे इतना क्लिनिक जाती है, तेरा खर्चा ही ज्यादा है, तेरा इनकम कुछ नहीं है, बंद कर दे. करेक्ट, लिखो पहले विजन क्या है लाइफ का आगे. विजन, मेरे को बहुत पैसा कमाने का क्लिनिक खोल के. लिखो यस नो आई वॉन्ट टू हैव अ वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस. लिखो विजन, राइट अ विजन. नो आई वॉन्ट टू हैव अ सक्सेसफुल लाइफ. आई वॉज अ डेंटिस्ट, आई हैव अ डिग्री, आई नो आई कैन मेक इट. देन राइट द मिशन, हाउ विल यू अचीव दिस विजन, हाउ टू डू दिस. करेक्ट, देन राइट द गोल, ए 3 year गोल, 3 to 5 एंड अ 10 year गोल. देन राइट द टारगेट डेट्स, दैट दिस ईयर आई विल हैव दिस 5 gurus कंप्लीटेड. This year I will be seeing that I would start only doing this in practice. I will see that by this time I'll have 3 consultants coming to my practice. Set all this, correct? Set your money concepts right, perfect on paper. Go with a planned business plan as per Dr. Manish Chitnis teaches in DBM. Have a proper business plan, not only to run your clinic as a business, have a plan for your life. Everything on paper, and keep looking at your paper every week at least once and see where life will take you. When you have that goal and target in front of you, you can achieve things for sure. When you don't write these things, when you don't, you know, then life goes everywhere. It just floats as life. And I bolte na, jindagi, sir, jindagi chal rahi hai, jindagi jahan ja rahi hai, wahan le ja raha hu, wahan le ja rahi hu. No. You need to be the captain of your ship. The waves can't take you here and there. You need to take the waves. You need to ride your ship on those waves. Okay? So take control of your life and start your practice if you want to. Start working with a dentist if you want to. You know? Stand on your 2 feet now. Chalo, again. Anybody? Question?
Yes, sir.
Dr. Kanwar has.
Yeah. Kanwar, hopefully the second last one. Bol.
Sir, last one. Almost all the queries have been solved. The last one, coming back to ladies again, the health issues I want to discuss. Usually, it's not gender related. Males and females, they are completely, they both have same health issues, the backaches, the cervicals. But we being ladies, we being treated with the C-section, with those injections in the backbone, I think we really need to take care of our health if we need to practice after 60s, especially for our back. We just rely on calcium. We just take a pill of calcium and we see it's good. Fine. Calcium is fine.
I
want to say calcium is not enough if you want to practice after 60.
I got it. I am not an MBBS doctor to answer the calcium part, but I got what you want to say.
Yeah,
so that is this way. I unfortunately am not a woman, so I've not undergone a C-section. But I promise that I would love to get pregnant someday. And I always keep telling my wife, even at this age, you know, let's try and make me pregnant. Okay, so Abhishek and Anand, go home tonight and please request your wife to try at least tonight to make you pregnant. Okay, before I proceed on the question and I forget, I often meet women in my course and I ask a question. Now I want to answer in the comments box quickly. Have you women in your brain ever a thought has crossed or you feel that you women only have to go through this delivering a baby and all? I wish sometime men could have this experience. How many women Sayogita ko out kar de is panel se for some time? She is the wrong lady to be on any panel. She can spoil the game completely. I'm telling in front of her, you know. She just cannot control her emotion, you know. She needs to wait till I complete. Get her back, she'll feel bad. So side acha hua change hua tha. She's better on the other side. So, kidhar tha mai dekh Sayogita, you make me lose my this thing. Kidhar tha? Ha. So if you have a feeling that only women have to go through this, you know, and you know, you get really angry and you are khunnas about it in Hindi language. Are you khunnas hai sir, you know, sab humko hi jhelna padta hai. Mere paas ek simple upay hai, जिनको जिनको ऐसे लगता है ना कि सर हमको ही झेलना पड़ता है, पूरे खुन्नस के साथ. देयर इज नो सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर वर्ड खुन्नस इन इंग्लिश. इज देयर एनी वर्ड खुन्नस इन इंग्लिश? रिवेंज, रिवेंज है ना, बट मजा नहीं है रिवेंज में. खुन्नस, टेक ओथ टूडे दैट यू विल फ्रॉम टूडे ट्राई टू मेक योर हस्बैंड प्रेग्नेंट. Okay, I just passed on a message for a very, very happy, long-lasting married life. I hope you got my message. Understood? So, is revenge ko na pyar mein badli kar diya maine. Correct? Because I can openly say on this forum, the more often you will have this revengeful khunnas sex, the more the happy married life you're going to have for sure. That's definitely. That's why probably humans get married, if you really ask me. Yes or no? Correct? Otherwise, why would society make this concept called marriage? Barabar ki nahi? Haan, to socho. Haan, to kidhar tha question tera tha?
Yes, sir. The question
is... Yoga karo. My wife has been teaching this for several years now. She does not have a single backache. She does not even complain of these things. And all these things, according to me, is nonsense. That C-section mein spinal cord mein injection dene se backache hota hai. This is nobody can. You can overcome this problem definitely by exercise, by yoga, by multiple things in life. Okay? So don't be into that medical thing. You know? I'm not the right man because I am not such a 100% physically fit man. I've neglected my body a lot in life and probably continue to do so also for some extent. So I'm not the right person to say and comment on health. But my wife, you're welcome to join her online programs. She's been taking a course for 50,000 policemen of Maharashtra. She and her organization Art of Living, she's one of the main person in it. She's taking courses for all frontline doctors from all top hospitals in Mumbai and Delhi and major cities of India. She's taking courses for nurses, dentists, ward boys, x-ray technicians. Every day she's taking two courses for 2 hours each. And they're all free of cost. She's also in the give mode. So I invite Dr. Kanwar to join the course immediately so that backache will vanish. Okay? Good. Any more questions?
I think we are done with today's question.
Mansi Pawaskar is happy. Abu Sumaya is happy. Dipali Chopra is happy. And so many. Neha Sharma and Jigasya Bharadwaj. We are more than happy than all of you, friends. So before we finish, I would say, we meet again on 11th of June, which is Thursday, 4th June, with Dr. Christian Coachman, Part 2 on Digital Smile Design and DSD. All those who have missed Part 1, it is available on WDA Facebook page. It will be also available on my website. The website is below. All those who missed my 5 episodes with WDA, they are all on my website presently, so you can definitely watch. You can connect with me on my WhatsApp for anything, and I promise to answer each one of you. If you have put comments box me a lot of things today, trust me, Facebook does not allow to see more than 150-200 comments. After Facebook locks me after that, they block me. So if you have typed a question on Facebook comments and you are expecting an answer, please type the same question on my WhatsApp and send me to receive an answer. Okay? So once again, to begin with, I will thank my panelists. I wish we could have got far 4 more panelists live, but next time we will try that game. I have to thank Anand again. I have to thank Abhishek. I would have to request to accept my membership to WBA. If you can take this, senior citizens are allowed. I am not yet age-wise the exact senior citizen, but if you are allowing me, I would love to join in for sure and add value to WBA. Beyond expectation, that's my promise. And of course, lastly, to the whole WDA team, and of course, thank you to all the listeners. You have given me life lockdown, because today I can share one thing. I have developed a little fear of catching the virus. Okay? And I'm not going out of the house for that reason, except dropping my wife to the so that she gets her this thing. But I have developed a small fear, and keep coming in my life through messages through Facebook to cheer me up so that I pass this phase in the coming months and I'm back in action in dentistry. So thank you once again. Bye-bye. See
you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
sir. Thank
you once again, sir.
Thanks a lot, sir.
In dentistry.
Thank you, Abhishek. Thank you, Alan. Thank you,
WTA
team.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thanks a lot, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
2 hours, 30 minutes.